coast to coast.
Clear the runway. He's coming in.
It's a helicopter slam jam.
The pull up from three. Count.
Watch this guy go.
Dribble drive. Backs it in and gets it.
Welcome to the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex. Day two has turned into night number two. We're getting ready for another championship, this time on the girls' side. The girls' 5A championship, Battle of Region 6. Miller Grove coming in with a record of 25-5. Southwest DeKalb with a record of 23-8. Good evening from the center of it all. Macon Madness, John here, Sean here. And it's a rematch of last year's championship game. No secrets as they play for the fifth time.
No secrets. Both teams are going to come out here with two things, heart and hustle.
Now, you talk about these particular squads. They know each other backwards, forwards, region play all the way through. And when you have a particular activity like this, you see each other 12 months out of the year. It means that much more in this particular game.
Well, John, you hit the nail on the head, 12 months of the year. These two schools are the biggest rivals in their conference. They're next-door neighbors. So on top of just seeing each other all year long, they're going to see each other during the offseason as well, too. So this is a game about bragging rights, also versus your biggest rivalry of the year.
All right, let's talk about the defending champs in Miller Grove, and they've got a big presence. And Tashi Thompson, someone who decided to take a nickname and stuck with it.
Deuce, as I called her last year. What she does is special. She's a great shooter. You see her stroke right there. She's going to come out and try to knock down the three early, get some early points on the board.
Now, you talk about Miller Grove. That's one team down. Kathy Walton trying to get her fourth title at Southwest DeKalb. And a young person shall lead them this time around.
Yeah, Tynese Martin. Martin, I love this girl. What she does is very special with her athletic ability and the way that she rebounds and defends. She'll score off the dribble. She'll score offensive opportunities of attacking the glass. She'll be all over the place. She's a special player, one you'll love to watch.
Third member of our broadcast team is going to patrol the sidelines for us this evening, Raven Tirado. Raven, what's the early word?
Good evening, John. Guys, this game is unique, like you mentioned before. This is the fifth meeting for these two teams tonight. I was talking to Coach Walton earlier, and she's concerned about the experience of her team. She says, we're young. She goes, I don't know if that's going to go in our favor or go against us. You know, if it's going to be scrappy basketball or the enthusiasm will work in their favor. I asked her also, I was like, has this turned into a rivalry since I've left the high school basketball scene? She says, actually, it has. Even though Miller Grove has only been around for maybe about 9 years, she goes, the fact that we've played them so much has created really a big rivalry between these two teams, so they're looking for blood tonight.
All right, Raven Tirado, thank you very much. We will be listening to you all night on the sidelines. Take a look at our starting lineups brought to us by our friends at Regions Bank. It's time to expect more. What we expect from Miller Grove is going to be Shaquanda Durden, Tashi Thompson, Katie Hunt, Clarissa Weaver, who's heading to UNC Asheville, and Nefi Udofia is the fifth member of the starting five for Miller Grove. For Southwest DeKalb, Wingate, Walker, Dysa Alexander, Tynese Martin, who we just focused on, and Maya Crowder, the fifth member of the starting five for Kathy Walton. Now let's take a look at the keys to the game, starting off with Miller Grove. Keys to the game brought to us by our friends at the Technical College System of Georgia, TCSG. Learn more, earn more. Sean, for Miller Grove.
Hey, Miller Grove, stay focused. Yes, you're up 3-1 in the series for the season, but stay focused. This is what it's all about. Again, going back to that loss, revenge.
Go to the flip side in Southwest DeKalb. What about them?
Just do a great job of protecting the basketball. You're going to see the pressure there for Miller Grove. Continue to fight. She has a very young squad this year, so continue to fight. And Coach Walt knows her team is in for a long battle this evening.
Once again, keys to success for the game brought to us by our friends at TCSG, the Technical College System of Georgia. Learn more, earn more. There's Southwest DeKalb and Kathy Walton. Kathy Walton won 2008, 2009, 2010. She brings out the young squad for Southwest DeKalb this time around in a rematch from last year's championship game. A stretch earlier in the year, Southwest DeKalb had actually lost 4 of 6. And that was in December to the end of the year. So they were at a point to where they were actually hovering around 500. Started the year 6-5. So you're talking about a great turnaround for Kathy Walton at the right time. They've won their last 7 games coming into the championship. And there's your tip. Picked up by Southwest DeKalb. Southwest DeKalb first half will be going from right to left. They are in the light-colored uniforms in the Miller Grove dark. Miller Grove, the Wolverines, will be heading from left to right as you watch.
Miller Grove looks like they're playing in a matchup zone, extending their pressure, forcing Southwest DeKalb to play deeper outside on the perimeter.
Ball knocked out of bounds 20 seconds in. going to stay with Southwest DeKalb. There's Renee Breedlove. Getting the first championship for the Wolverines last season. For the girls, now the girls are playing right there with the guys when it comes to championship basketball, much like Columbia yesterday when it comes to talking about Miller Grove basketball. You're now talking about the boys and the girls.
You're exactly right. Coach Breedlove just trying to mimic what the boys are doing and having a good, successful season.
Tashi Thompson can't control the pass into the paint. And it's a turnover for Southwest DeKalb. 35 seconds in, no score. And is it almost to where you've seen each other five times? It's almost mirror images, and you don't want to play on autopilot even though you know what to expect.
I know, it's going to be blood. It's going to be blood at the beginning of the stage of this game. Both teams want to come out in attack mode, show who's a better team in the beginning.
There's Kathy Walton, head coach for Southwest DeKalb, 25-year resident of DeKalb County. She's had a couple of kids go through the system, so she knows what DeKalb County basketball has been all about as both a coach and a parent. Foul on Clarissa Weaver, her first of the ball game for everyone. Shot up, no good, knocked out of bounds, and we'll try it again. You want to talk about a person that you really can get great advice from. Can't get any better advice than from Buck Godfrey at Southwest DeKalb, the longtime head football coach there, legend in DeKalb County. You want to talk about a sounding board. Kathy Walton got one, and Buck coming right out of the box.
And she got a great sophomore here doing the same thing. We talked about Tanise Smart in the beginning, her athletic ability and ability to rebound. She did a great job securing the offensive rebound with a chance to get 2 points on the board.
Tanise Martin with the free throw up and good. And Clarissa Weaver picks up her second foul in the first minute of the game. So something to put a circle on for all of us right now.
Hey, John, she has a chance to explode. Looking at her stroke compared to where it was last year, it's a lot smoother. She's playing a lot more under control. Tanise Martin could go off for a huge game tonight.
Sarai Blissett in now. Clarissa Weaver taking a seat after only 55 seconds of action. Might be a concern for head coach Breedlove as we continue to go. Bounce pass inside, almost off the glass. It looks like it was partially blocked and knocked out of bounds.
Well, Southwest DeKalb, they're attacking. They're getting the ball inside, post play. But here's the thing about early jitters, John. Whenever you can get to the free throw line early in the game, now you actually put pressure on the defense because now they want to play without fouling as the game continues to grow.
Maya Crowder with the first free throw up and in. 3-0 now, Southwest DeKalb, a minute 4 in. Second free throw up and short. Rebound picked up by Miller Grove. Like we saw earlier today, ways to beat the press and get it down before very quickly is try to do loop pass, and they worked the diagonal. Almost called a carry there, or could have called a carry. They didn't. So Miller Grove's now going to try to work their offense around the perimeter.
Good man-to-man pressure by Southwest DeKalb. Just stand in front of the person you're guarding.
Tashi Thompson inside off the back of the rim. No good. Fought for a rebound. Up and in by Sarai Blissett. 3-2. Miller Grove's first points on the board. Ball stolen away. Miller Grove 2-for-2. Coming down. Pull up off the elbow. Too strong. Fought for on the inside off the hands of looked like Katie Hunt. And it's going to go to Southwest DeKalb coming back.
Both teams playing up and down the court with a lot of speed and a lot of energy. You have to come down sooner or later to play within the solid river.
Let's see who can do that first. Miller Grove with three-quarter court pressure. Looks like almost a 2-2-1 trap. Southwest DeKalb beats it, gets it across half court. They'll try to figure out a way to set up their offense. Bounce pass inside, double clutch, off the rim, no good. Fought for on the inside, almost a jump ball situation. Looked like it was bounced off of Tanise Martin out of bounds. Let's see where it stays. Looks like it's going to go to Miller Grove. They're going to say that Martin kicked it, so it's a turnover, and Miller Grove will inbound.
Yeah, you're doing a great job of securing their rebound. They're off the miss by Southwest DeKalb. It's need a better outlet so she can't get chucked underneath the basket.
Dangerous right at the half court line. Nephi Udofia with the inbound. And so now setting up the offense is Katie Hunt. Looking to dribble drive, stops at the elbow, pass. Tashi Thompson and a foul on the inside, probably Tanise Martin. Change it over to Ariel Walker. Here's a look at your foul on Walker.
Yeah, this Tashi just getting a chance to drive by. She's leading score on this team with 13.9 points a game. She can get to hit to the free throw line and get into the books.
First free throw up and in. Substitution for Southwest DeKalb. Marcin DeShazer in. Ariel Walker out. Second free throw, rims out, no good.
There's a press off the miss. Southwest DeKalb, watch for the back tip.
Easy,
good pull up.
Easy break. Ball deflected by Sarai Blessed. And they're going to call a whistle. And Lissette gets her second foul. So that's two players, two pieces of tall timber for Miller Grove getting two fouls very, very quickly. We're 2.5 minutes in, yeah. Two players with two fouls in
yeah,
the front.
Yeah, John, both teams don't want this type of called game. You want to have the players play, let the players decide the championships and not necessarily the whistles by the official.
First free throw up and in for Alexander. As is the second, Southwest DeKalb now up 5-3. And there's a look at your referees. Howard Hall's the ref. Jill Poole and Nikki Crawford are working the edges. Coming up on 3 minutes gone here, first quarter. Southwest DeKalb leading Miller Grove 5-3. As we determine the Class 5A champion, it will be out of Region 6. We just don't know who yet. Looks like they're calling a kick ball. It'll be a turnover by Miller Grove. Southwest DeKalb will bring it back down.
Yeah, just Johnson's
called a foul.
Well, they called a foul, but there's so much aggression going on right now, and the officials actually need to realize that and maybe cut back or actually coach the players together here sometime on the next dead ball.
Blissett with three fouls, Clarissa Weaver with two fouls, all in the first 2 minutes and 50 seconds for Miller Grove.
Well, you know, that's to be expected. Both teams are going to attack one another. This is their fifth time meeting, so don't think they're going to come out and play passive. Everybody's in the attack mode to show what they can do to win this championship. That was a good finish there underneath the basket for Southwest DeKalb.
Maya Crowder with the two. He's cleared 3 minutes gone. Southwest DeKalb now up 7-3. Pull-up pop inside is good for Clarissa Weaver, who had to come back in. And notice that she retreated back down the floor very, very quickly.
Yes, nice touch there for 10 feet men. Good penetration, good pass, good catch, nice stroke.
Miller Grove cuts the Southwest DeKalb advantage to two. Miller Grove called for delay of game. We got to keep an eye on that now, too. Could turn out being a technical foul the other way. Turnover by Southwest DeKalb. Miller Grove with their pressure. Pass to the inside off the glass. Up and in for two. Katie Hunt.
Yeah, good finish here by Hunt. Good pass. Good play by our girl. Deuce. Deshaun Deja.
Tied at seven now. 4.5 minutes and counting in the first quarter. Southwest DeKalb looking. Jumper off the rim. No good. Rebound coming back out. Tashi Thompson. Double team. Ball on the floor. Did they get the timeout called in time? Then they did not get the timeout called in time.
Possession error.
So it's to Miller Grove.
John, both teams are pressing. 7-7 game, 4 minutes and 12 seconds here in the first quarter. Still trying to get a rhythm of the game. Both players, all the players are going up or down the court, aggressively attacking.
Trying to do a teardrop from the elbow. Didn't quite work. Out of the scrum, Miller Grove comes back out with it. They're going to try to reset under 4 minutes to go here in the first. Katie Hunt backing it out for Miller Grove, looking to drive. Stops at the elbow, pass, baseline jumper, misses everything. Back up, no good. Miller Grove missing a second opportunity. Back comes Southwest DeKalb. Miller Grove picking up the pressure just past half court. Just outside three-point line, count it.
Wow, that's something she's added to her arsenal. That young lady's gonna be special down the road. Great stroke there by Martin.
Tyrese Martin with the three. 9-7 Southwest DeKalb. Martin now with 4 points. Going around. Own pick. Pass inside. Intercepted by Southwest DeKalb. And they'll come back the other way with it. Davian Wingate crosses over. Martin pulls up again. Off the rim, no good. Rebound picked up by Southwest DeKalb. Going back inside with it. Off the glass, up and in. Easy two for Tynese Martin.
Right, we talked about Martin at the beginning. If she explodes, could be, it will be in Southwest DeKalb's favor. Now she has at least 6-7 points here in the first quarter.
Whistles. As Tashi Thompson was trying to bring it across midcourt. Darsane DeShazer called for the foul. For Southwest DeKalb, that is her first, and we're going to take a break. 2:49 to go, first quarter. Southwest DeKalb leading Millard Grove. Millard Grove trying to get their penetration and trying to repeat as champs. Region 6 will have your champ. We'll have the answer when we come back here on GPB from Macon Madness and the Macon Centerplex. Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, 2:49 for the first quarter here. And Sean, the biggest issue is foul trouble, and that's all in black right now.
Yeah, exactly right there. That's Bissette there to your right with three fouls, and to your left, and Weaver to your right with two fouls here in the first quarter, John. And both teams combined with seven fouls here in the first 6 minutes, 7 minutes, 5 minutes here of the quarter. And that's not good because the fouls are now controlling the tempo of the game, John.
You talk about teams that want to play up and down the floor. You get fouls, it starts and stops, and you're not able to get any kind of a tempo or a rhythm for a championship.
You're exactly right. And not to be critical in a certain way, but as an official, you got to understand what's at stake here. This is their fifth time playing. The style of play they do play, and there are going to be some fouls. You just can't call everyone. Allow the players to make the plays.
Miller Grove had missed their last four before making that shot right there. Southwest DeKalb has made three of their last five. Tashi Thompson with the bucket. Now Millard Grove is 4 of 9 from the floor here in the first. Southwest DeKalb 3 of 9. Southwest DeKalb up 11-10. Missed the shot there. Took a swipe trying to get the ball back after the miss. Millard Grove coming back out with it. Good spin to keep an eye on it was Katie Hunt, and she's going to spin to get out of traffic.
Yeah, she's doing a great job of controlling the ball, especially versus the press, but you got to no forced turnovers. That was an unforced turnover right there. Just be simple with your play.
Hunt was trying to get it to Tashi Thompson, and in all of the scrum and battle, it was last touched by Thompson to bring it back. And look at those numbers right there. Millard Grove, 6 boards, 4 turnovers. Southwest DeKalb, 3-3-3. Southwest DeKalb under 2 minutes to go, dribbling into the paint. Up 11-10, ball out of bounds. It's going to go back to Millard Grove.
Again, there's no rhythm, John. Everyone's just going a little helter-skelter, playing through the fouls, not being in a smooth rhythm, a smooth mindset. It may take us another quarter to get that rhythm going.
Took a look at Tynese Martin there. She's got 6 points leading Southwest DeKalb, one of 3 players to score. Crowder has 3. Alexander has the other 2. For Miller Grove, Tashi Thompson with 4. Hunt, Weaver, and Bissette with 2 each. Pass inside, batted away. Nice pressure by Southwest DeKalb. Pass all the way down floor, and a nice hack on the way up to try to prevent the bucket.
Now, John, you put took the words right out of my mouth. That was a hack. Good foul, solid foul, not allowing the easy basket in transition. But again, we haven't got to a solid pace, a rhythm within the game.
Fouling Katika Brown, her first. 94 seconds to go for the first free throw up and in by Darsane DeShazer. Southwest DeKalb, champs 2008, 2009, 2010. Renee Breedlove got Miller Grove, their first championship on the women's side last year, looking to repeat in a rematch of last year's championship game. 90 seconds to go, first quarter. Miller Grove in their offensive end. Katie Hunt backing it out, playing a two-person game with Tashi Thompson. Katika Brown are all working the perimeter right now, trying to figure out a way to get in to penetrate that Southwest DeKalb defense.
You're exactly right, John.
70 seconds to go. Miller Grove having a lot of problems working it in.
You know, John, not necessarily. I think they want to get a good shot. Sometimes you got to take your time and be patient. See, the defense gives you instead of forcing it, because a forced shot is equivalent to a turnover.
Tashi Thompson doing exactly that, coming back the other way, trying to do well defensively to get the ball back. Jumper no good. And Thompson comes out with it, double-teamed after the rebound, but Miller Grove trying to come down to the break, not looking for it. That particular time was Clarissa Weaver out of bounds, and it's going to head back to Southwest DeKalb.
Hey, John, we talked about at the beginning of the broadcast how focused this Miller Grove team needs to be. With the turnovers, with the carelessness, with the fouls, the focus may have slipped a little bit, and the advantage now may be leading towards Southwest DeKalb.
44 seconds remaining in the quarter. We'll see if Southwest DeKalb can work on their two-point advantage that they've got right now. Pressure all the way out to the half-court line by Miller Grove.
No need to foul that far away from the basket. Just stay in front of the offense. Move your feet.
Tynese Martin looking to drive. Throws it up against the glass, trying to do something. They're going to call steps.
Yeah, she was very fortunate because that would have been a charge there on Martin. She didn't need that, especially this early in the game.
Miller Grove coming down with 20 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Down a bucket with all of this helter-skelter stop-and-start pace, down to 12.9 now. Miller Grove will hang on to it. You see right there, Renee Breedlove is not happy with what's going on in the first 8 minutes.
I don't think both coaches are happy right now because they just can't get a sequence of good, solid basketball going with all the stopping and on all the fouls.
Looking to pass it in from the corner, knocked away. 10 seconds to go, off the rim, no good. Second chance, blocked, third chance, off the bottom of the backboard. Coming out with it, 3-2-1. Kathy Walton wanted a travel. We got a whistle now with 8 tenths. And Southwest DeKalb up 2. Miller Grove coming into that possession had only made one of their last 7, and that possession didn't necessarily improve matters much.
No, it did not, John.
Foul on Brown will be her second.
It's a lot of activity going down underneath the basket.
And that's going to do it for the end of the first quarter. Southwest DeKalb up 12-10 after one. It's a rematch of the 2012 championship game. Region 6 going to have their champion. After the next 24 minutes, we're going to come up to see who's going to take advantage here in the second quarter. We return to Macon here on GPB. In the memory you overflow, wanna be your superhero. Welcome back to the center of it all, the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex. Folks coming here for a 3-day party, 15 championship games. We are in the middle of day number 2, heading toward the end of day number 2 here in Class 5A. And by the way, you know you can watch Georgia Outdoors from inside your living room. You're able to cozy up with bats, frogs, hang on the beach with sea turtles, and kayak down the Altamaha River. Get wild with Sharon Collins in nature. Watch Georgia Outdoors in the great GPB. Sharon Collins, videographer Shane Keating, shoot some amazing stories and take us to some amazing places on Georgia Public Broadcasting. It's a gorgeous show, and you get it right here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. Miller Grove cheerleaders, what does the young kids say these days, Sean? Representing?
Representing or representing?
Representing.
Representing.
That's what I was trying to figure out.
Representing, yo.
Okay. So that's what the Miller Grove cheerleaders are doing.
Representing, yo.
They're down 2 after 8 minutes.
Well, here's the thing, though, John. Miller Grove needs to understand this. Whenever a team makes more free throws than you attempt, Southwest DeKalb 6-8 from the free throw line, the first quarter, Miller Grove 1-2, that's a recipe for disaster.
That's your 5-point difference right there in a 2-point game. Miller Grove working with it on offense. Start of the second quarter, down 12-10. Shaquan to Durden with it for Miller Grove, looking inside, instead kicking it back to Nephi Udokia.
The Miller Grove come out now, a lot of movement, a lot of back screens, UCLA cut, UCLA screen, block-to-block screens, good movement, patience, trying to wear down the defense and get a high percentage shot. That was good coaching there out of the timeout there from Coach Breedlove.
Kaylin Kelly with the foul. That's going to be her first foul. Here's Coach Breedlove still looking like she's trying to find an equation that's going to work for her.
Yeah, and I think she just found it there, John. Watch the movement. Going to force Southwest DeKalb to actually switch on screens, help on the drives. A lot of movement in that half-court offense now for Miller Grove.
Shaquanda Durden looking past for Tashi Thompson, not far enough. Comes back for the block, but the skip back is up and in for Southwest DeKalb and Tynese Martin.
Yeah, Durden just not comfortable out there on the perimeter, trying to do too much. Created a turnover and 2 easy baskets there for Southwest DeKalb.
Margin now 14-10, a minute in. It looked like it was kicked by Kaylin Kelly. Turnover battle now 9-4. Miller Grove. And we're only 9 minutes into play, and they've already got 9 turnovers. Willow Grove will inbound underneath the basket. Try to spring somebody along. They just lob it over the top into the paint. Quick turn. Jumper off the glass. No good. Rebound fought for. Southwest DeKalb's going to come out with it. Maya Crowder inside. Gives it to Davian Wingate. Southwest DeKalb will bring it up.
Well, John, there's a lot of fight in the Southwest DeKalb team. They've come out at the beginning. First quarter here in the second quarter with a lot of heart and hustle and determination in tonight's contest.
Wingate, Kelly, Crowder. Three of the five for Southwest DeKalb as we start the second quarter. Shot by Wingate, no good. Katie Hunt with it for Miller Grove, trying to dribble through two, if not three, Southwest DeKalb players.
Simplify the game, Hunt. Simplify the game. Trying to do too much. And, John, we talked about focused in the beginning. They may be focused in the wrong mindset, focused to actually win the game or play the game. You got to play the game first before you win it.
10th turnover in the game for Miller Grove. They've only hit one of their last seven from the floor. Southwest DeKalb only has hit one of their last five. See if they can improve on that here with this particular possession as we approach 2 minutes gone. Second quarter, 6 minutes to go, first half. Kelly and Wingate up top. Loop pass inside to Tynese Martin, looking to drive off the elbow. Tries to throw it up, knocked up. And Southwest DeKalb trying to drive. Kaylin Kelly, ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to go to Miller Grove, fifth turnover for Southwest DeKalb.
Well, John, if you've noticed, the officials have kind of held their whistles on the last few plays here in both possessions of the ball. So I think the officials are now going to let these girls play and see who determines to be on top of the end.
Off the glass, easy two that time for Katie Hunt. Hunt now with 4 points. We're back to 14-12 in a two-point ball game for Southwest DeKalb.
Yeah, that's the strength for Hunt, being able to use her size and strength to get inside the paint with a pull-up jump shot. She may need to do that a little bit more to clear a victory tonight.
Wingate looking to drive, kicks it out. 2 points good for Darsan DeShazer. They're going to give her a three to make it 16-12. So DeShazer with the bucket has 3 points in the ball game. Here's a look at the DeShazer two.
Nice stroke, good follow through, great rhythm. Deuce, deuce, baby, deuce, deuce. That's what I called her, and she's been holding on to that, John. With a stroke like that, she could end up with 22 points tonight.
We'll see if she continues to earn it. Foul on Kaylin Kelly, that'll be her second. She checks out for Southwest DeKalb. Off the elbow jumper, no good by Eudophia. Fighting for it and trying to maintain possession, Miller Grove. Kick it all the way back out. Shaquanda Durden looking to pass. No one there. Turnover goes over to Southwest DeKalb. Coach Breedlove looking to substitute very quickly. Katika Brown coming back in, replacing Shaquanda Durden. And it looks like she's still trying to find that right combination.
Still trying to find it. Still trying to find it. Just hadn't smoothed out yet. Could possibly take an entire half. Hopefully not the entire game.
Bottom line is you want to make the tablecloth smooth so it looks good for dinner when you're serving everybody, right?
It doesn't matter how it looks, John, just as long as we eat. Now you want to win.
4:45 to go first half, 16-12 Southwest DeKalb. Nephi Eudophia looking to inbound for the Wolverines, and they'll bring it up fairly slowly this time. Sharika Brown in the game now for Miller Grove. Southwest DeKalb so far 10-4 when it comes to points off of turnovers in this particular ballgame. Knocked out of bounds by Davian Wingate. She's going square up to Sharika Brown. She won that battle, knocked it out of bounds. Miller Grove's going to have to reset. Katika Brown and Tashi Thompson getting a bit of a break this time.
Yeah, both teams trying to, again, find that rhythm, get the right players in, give the players that played a lot a minute. It's a little bit of rest, hoping to finish out the first half.
Dangerous inbound pass to Imani Richardson, trying to loop it over. Loop it over the top. Two passes. Quick. Eudophia gets blocked right as she tried to throw it by Tynese Martin.
Good offensive basketball, passing and moving. But here's the good block underneath by Martin, just timing it right. Nice block, young lady, nice block. Good athletic ability. She's going to be special. Only a sophomore.
Martin guarding the inbound, gets a piece of it. But Miller Grove comes up with it. He's going to call alternating possession, and it's going to go the other way.
And Martin calls that being active. Jumping, deflections. She's doing things to her strength, definitely not to her weakness.
Easy two that time for Clarissa Weaver. She definitely needed that to try to get on the board.
Yes, she did.
16-14 Southwest DeKalb, 4:20 to go first half. The Shays are trying to bring it up the floor.
Here's good pressure the ball, using your length, great deflection, great steal, finish with the left off the glass. Great job, Weaver.
Weaver, we say, heading to North Carolina Asheville when her days are done here at Miller Grove. 4:15 and counting first half. Working it into the corner, this time into the paint. Spin move off the right hand, off the glass, no good. Miller Grove coming out with it. Trying to work their way back down in transition, down two, possibly the tie, maybe even take the lead with a three. And you see the tenacious defense by Southwest DeKalb. Hands yes. up always, hands
yes.
up.
Steals, deflections, again, another deflection. Martin getting our hands on the ball, causing the turnover there.
Katika Brown loses control, and it's gonna go over to Southwest DeKalb when we come back. 3 seconds past the halfway point here in the second quarter. Southwest DeKalb leading Miller Grove 16-14. Tough defense is the way of the day so far. We'll have more when we come back to the Macon Coliseum and the great GPB. Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex, 3:57 for the second quarter. Southwest DeKalb leading Miller Grove in this battle of Region 6 for the 5A Championship, 16-14. And hey, by the way, for the third year in a row, Georgia Public Broadcasting Sports proudly brings you every pass, run, block, and tackle as the 2013 Georgia high school football season kicks off in the Georgia Dome with the 22nd annual Corky Cal Classic Saturday, August 24th. Five big games, five classic matchups, breakfast, lunch, dinner. Teams represented from all over the state. Colquitt, Camden, Metro Atlanta teams involved as well. 22nd annual Corky Cal Classic kicking off bright and early 9 a.m. for a football extravaganza, quoting Mark Harmon, here on the great GPB. And you see the shiny bling. Bling, right?
Bling, bling, playing for a ring.
Okay.
Bling, bling, playing for a ring. That's the new motto of GPB basketball.
There's your bling
There's
right there.
There's the bling.
Right there.
Playing for a ring. I like that. I just made that up, John.
Hey.
John and Sean, bling, bling, playing for a ring.
John and Sean, bring it on. Bling, bling, playing for a ring.
Playing for a ring.
I can get my upper plate to work.
In making.
Right.
In making.
That's close. You got to see if you can come up with a rhyme for cherry blossom.
I can't rhyme, John. I cannot rhyme.
What happened for the last 30 seconds? What are you talking about? Southwest DeKalb breaking pressure. There's your game stats. Big rebounding advantage right there for Miller Grove and a big two for Southwest DeKalb and Deja Clay.
Yeah. Great finish down low. Breaking the press. Simplifying it with a finish there for the Deuce.
Second quarter field goal number. Southwest DeKalb 3 of 5. Miller Grove 2 for 5. 60% and 40% Southwest DeKalb up 4, 18-14. Getting close to 3 minutes to go here in the first half to determine the Class 5A championship. Pass on the inside on the cut. They're going to call steps on the way down for Tashi Thompson.
Southwest DeKalb doing a great job of attacking. First of all, with the pass, but getting the pass half court against any kind of pressure. Don't pull up, attack at the rim. Good catch by Clay. Good finish.
14th Miller Grove turnover, only 7 so far for Southwest DeKalb in the ballgame. Far too many turnovers to be down by only 4. 3 minutes to go in the first half. Davian Wingate looking for an entry. Deja Clay spinning around trying to find someone to pass to. Cutter doesn't quite work. Turnover to Miller Grove. But you get Clay diving for it after she makes the pass.
Yeah.
Southwest DeKalb coming out with it. Wingate with the jumper off the rim, no good. Miller Grove's going to try it again. You have 4 bodies around it for Southwest DeKalb. They can't come out with it. Numbers for a brief second up and in. Foul on Deja Clay, the 2 to Clarissa Weaver.
See, Deja Clay was the key factor in that whole entire process, John. She was able to come down here, get the loose ball, get on the floor, got back up, sprinted down the court. Here's a good replay here. Does Deja Clay have to play up and down, use your verticality, and you won't have the foul.
Free throw off the back of the rim, no good. Southwest DeKalb's leads back to 2 at 18-16. 2.5 to go first half. Wingate looking to pass. Deja Clay in a dangerous place right at half court. Has to bring it up herself. A front court player having to cross half court. Shot up, no good. Fought for 2 for Southwest DeKalb going after it. We got a foul on the inside, it looks like. It's on Weaver, and that's going to be her 3rd. 2:13 to go first half. Clarissa Weaver is now saddled with three fouls. And they're going to bring in Crystal Ezechukwu, the ninth grader, to take over for Clarissa Weaver. First free throw is no good. Here's Weaver's number, 6'1", senior center, heading to NC Asheville.
She's a solid player, John. They're going to need her to be on the court in the second half. That's okay. It's only a two-point game with 2:13 to go in the half.
Second free throw off the front of the rim. No good. Fought for. Looked like over the back on Maya Crowder. We'll bring it back down the other way.
You know, a lot of times coaches say play hard, but at the same time, you have to play smart, John. That was not a smart play there, even though it looked hard from the outside for the fans, but wasn't a smart play to come on her back for the foul.
Coming up on 2 minutes to go, first half. Losing control of the basketball was Katie Hunt. Deja Clay on the floor one more time for Southwest DeKalb.
And see, the thing is, Deja Clay is being the one that's being very aggressive up front. She's not absorbing the fouls. She's the one receiving the fouls because the first one down on the floor, her aggression is something. Look at that. She's there on the floor. She's getting ready to get the loose ball. She's going to dive down, and she's going to be the one on the receiving end of the foul against Miller Grove.
Deja Clay very active in the last minute and a half to 2 minutes. Foul on Hunt. That'll be her first to go with her 4 points. Foul on the reach in, trying to go for the steal. Looks like they're going to call it on Katie Hunt.
Yeah, both teams now starting to reach a little bit more, getting down to the halftime point. You have to play with your feet first, not your hands, but your feet first. If the opportunity comes, John, to get the jump ball opportunity for the steal, that second, move your feet first.
They'll call it on Sharika Brown instead. It'll be her foul. First free throw up and in for Casey Kelly. Kelly, the 10th grade guard. Second free throw, good. She goes 2 for 2. 4 point margin now, 20-16. Davion Wingate now back in the ball game for Southwest DeKalb off the exchange. Good quality minutes for Casey Kelly. Gets her 2 points, gives Wingate a bit of a break. And now Wingate gets to come back in for the last 2 minutes of the second quarter. Miller Grove trying to work the outside. Katie Hunt, double team, dribbles through it. Bounce pass to the inside, off the glass, no good. Fought for inside, Udofia gets the two.
Yeah, to stand with the play, Udofia able to come up with the offensive rebound and a good putback to cut the lead down to two.
Coming up on 80 seconds to go, first half. Holding back nicely and putting the ball in with Dice Alexander.
Oh, my gosh. This Southwest DeKalb team was always going to attack. Made or miss baskets. They love transition basketball.
22-18, 70 seconds to go, first half. And a foul on Wingate on the reach-in. There's that last two coming down the floor.
There's Martin just attacking there in transition. Good finish there by Alexander. Nice freshman coming in, getting good minutes here in the state championship game. And she has a chance to possibly play for three more.
Tashi Thompson to the line now. On the season, a 73% free throw shooter. Misses the front end of the 1-1. Trying to work their way down the floor, Southwest DeKalb. And it looks like Katie Hunt's going to get called for the foul here. She was trying to get the basketball away from Tynese Martin as Martin was trying to break the press down
right,
the middle.
Right, right. And, you know, John, and take this the right way on Miller Grove's behalf, I think the girls are playing now not to lose the game. Instead of playing comfortable and relaxed, you're down by 4 points, 5 points now. They're feeling the pressure a little bit here in the first half, John. They've got to relax and go out and play consistent here coming up latter part of the first half and also through the second.
Tynese Martin with two free throws. It's a 24-18 as we're under a minute. Steps call, and it's going to go back the other way to Southwest DeKalb.
Yeah, the fear factor is starting to creep in now on this Miller Grove team. They've got to relax, keep their poise, and play solid.
Trying to do that defensively, and they're calling steps. As Tynese Martin was trying to break the press and come down the floor, instead it turns into the eighth turnover for Southwest DeKalb here in the ballgame. Kathy Walton talking defense on the inbounds. Double team in the corner. Deja Clay involved in all of that. Katie Hunt trying to figure a way to get into the paint. Looks like she took about four steps. No call. Block on the inside by Tynese Martin. Southwest DeKalb coming back with it. Wingate loses control of the basketball. But they're going to call Stepson. Bring it back the other way for Maya Crowder.
Yeah, Martin just showing her athletic ability. Him a defensive end with a few blocks in the first half. That's what she can do. Spearheading the fast break. Just not able to capitalize there. Going to the basket there. Crowder, number 32.
30 seconds to go in the first half. Southwest DeKalb up six.
Katie got a lot of bumping going on at 4-22. Got a lot of bumping going on.
And we got the official from the far side calls the whistle out.
I think it's going to be on Wingate there, trying to get on Thompson. Playing too aggressive outside of her mindset. That was an unnecessary foul. Very uncharacteristic. Not what was needed there going into halftime.
Second foul on Wingate. Tashi Thompson goes back to the free throw line. First free throw up and good. Kathy Walton telling her Southwest DeKalb players, you don't have to do that kind of stuff defensively to get
the job. Well, you know, a lot of times young players think that you have to fight. Physicality comes into the fight. You got to think the game and play the game, not get out there and make things happen. And right then, she just got caught emotionally in the play, gave 2 points over to Miller Grove.
19 personal fouls called in the first half, both teams. 23 seconds to go, first half. Miller Grove coming back with the press off the inbounds, down 4, 24-20.
There's a freshman coming down the court out of control. She got saved.
Deja Clay looking for the cutter off the elbow, not going to happen. Bringing it back around, looking for the pass to the inside. Probably did it too quickly, double teamed in the corner. 5 seconds, four. Miller Grove's going to have to do something in a hurry here. Blocked by Deja Clay out of bounds with 2 tenths to go.
Great block by Deja Clay. It's not even a catch and shoot right now. You can only tap the ball in with 0.2 on the clock. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. I don't think nothing's going to be successful.
Didn't get your catch and shoot. No basket there. Southwest DeKalb escapes the first 16 minutes, up 24-20. The battle of Region 6 to determine who's going to be the 5A champ. Let's send it over to Raven and Kathy Walton.
Coach, you're winning the turnover battle. You're doing pretty well on rebounds. What are you telling your girls to make sure they can ensure a win in the second half?
We just got to stay focused, stay aggressive. I mean, it's a physical game. We're used to each other, and we just have to keep on playing through it.
The girls, you were talking about their inexperience and being young, playing pretty well right now. What else do you need from them?
Well, there's times their youth shows up. You know, we just got to tell them they're going to make mistakes and just keep playing. You know, well, if they keep playing through, I think we'll be okay.
Okay, well, good luck, Coach.
Okay, thanks.
Hey, thanks very much. You know, it is a great weekend of high school basketball here on the great GPB as we bring you the GHSA Boys and Girls Championship live from the Macon Coliseum. Right now, Southwest DeKalb leading Miller Grove 24-20. Coming up at the half, we'll talk to both principals. We'll have stats. We'll have first half highlights. It's all coming up next on the GPB Halftime Show, live from Macon, only on GPB, and like us on Facebook. We are live at the Macon Coliseum, live on GPB. We are at the half of the girls' 5A state championship game. Southwest DeKalb leading Miller Grove 24-20 right now. A great three-day weekend of high school hoop right here on GPB. And now we welcome into the program the principal from Miller Grove High School, Matthew Priester. It's great to have you here, and we see you a lot. The boys are going for five straight. The girls are going for two straight.
Yes, absolutely. What we do is... I think we're going to run a program that's fully committed by the coaches, players, parents, community, and, you know, just keeps coming. And we're proud to just be here and honored just to be here to represent the DeKalb County school system one more time.
Well, 14 boys and girls school teams have won in the same year, just 14. You guys did it last year. What was the vibe at school like this year as you go for a repeat?
Well, I would say, to be honest, starting the year out, you know, the expectations weren't as high. Because, you know, we had a lot of seniors to graduate on last year. I think we lost five starters. on last year, got in a few new players, and some of the younger guys stepped up, and we're back here again. And the excitement and the commitment kind of picked up midway, and it's kind of trickled on through the community, parents, and now we're back here again.
You don't rebuild, you reload. That's
Absolutely.
Great. All right, time now to play Are You Smarter Than Your Students? A question from our Today in Georgia History Project. And your question is, Brenda Lee was the most successful female performer of the 1960s with 55 Billboard hits. She was the only female singer to do this. Was it A, be in both the Country and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, B, walk on the moon, C, be a rodeo clown, or D, eat crackers and whistle?
Well, Brenda Lee, I think from my history and listening to her music, I would say A.
And you're right. She was terrific, A, both in the Country and the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Listen, good luck in the second half of this one.
Thank you.
And we'll see you again for the boys.
Absolutely.
All right. Today in Georgia History is a joint production of the Georgia Historical Society and GPB. For more information, just go to todayingeorgiahistory.org. And now let's check in with Kat Carney with some social media information. Kat?
Thanks so much, Mark. You know what? We have just exciting, exciting basketball going on. And you know what? People are watching from all over. I just chatted with a gentleman named Purnell from Iowa who was enjoying the game on TV. But you know what? You don't just have to watch the game on TV. You can watch it online at gpb.org/sports. I'm here with Grace Olson, and you said people are watching online. They're talking about it.
Oh, they're talking about it. We have coaches from the state of Georgia that coached decades ago watching because their love for the game. They just love basketball. We have a coach that coached women's basketball a couple decades ago, and he's been chatting with us about today's game. That's really exciting to have him on here. You can see our chat going right there, and then right above the chat is where you click and you watch the game live on TV. Now, not only do we have everything going on our website at gpb.org/sports, we also have our Facebook. It is booming. The fans have been having so much fun here today. Therefore, I've been having so much fun because I've been interacting with them, taking photos, taking interviews, videos, uploading them. And we have had some of the coolest costumes here today, random costumes, people in fully highlighted outfits from head to toe, Barney outfits, Baby Bop. I've seen everything all day long. And you can see it right here, too, if you like GPB Sports on Facebook.
That's awesome. And everybody should log on and check out those crazy costumes and vote for the one that you like the most. And check in with Grace. She's going to be with us all weekend long. Back to you, Mark.
Kat, thanks so much. We're at halftime of the girls' 5A state championship game between Miller Grove and Southwest DeKalb. And we welcome now to the program the principal of Southwest DeKalb High School, Carolyn Williams. And Carolyn, talk a little bit of the vibe at school this week as the girls get ready to try to win another state championship.
Yes, we were all very, very excited. We were looking forward to this evening, and we believe that we're going to be victorious.
Well, you know, you've had a lot of success there at Southwest DeKalb High School. Talk about what's going on at your school these days.
Well, I think that even when I speak of the students, I think of the students that we can describe them, first of all, as student athletes. They are exceptional in the classroom, and they know that it's very, very important for them to excel academically, and that helps and assists them on the court as well.
Absolutely. You know, the girls have won a lot of state championships, so we wish you good luck to that. It's time now to play Are You Smarter Than Your Students? A question from our Today in Georgia History program. So your question is, starting the Home Depot on June 22nd, 1979, Bernie Marcus and Arthur Blank lost their jobs at this home improvement store first. Was it A, Handy Dan, B, Just Wrenches, C, Pails of Nails, or D, Bolts R Us?
It was A, Handy Dan.
And it turned out all right for those guys. They got fired, then became billionaires and owners of aquariums and Falcon football teams. So it turned out okay.
Yes.
Hey, good luck in the second
Thank
half. Thanks
so
for coming
much.
On with us.
Thank you.
All right.
It.
Today in Georgia History is a joint production of the Georgia Historical Society and GPB. For more information, just go to todayingeorgiahistory.org. Now let's check back in with Kat.
That's right. Now it's time for Play of the Game, presented by the Technical College System of Georgia. You know, Georgia continues to grow its service sector economy, and jobs in the hospitality industry are growing too. Thousands of positions for chefs, food and beverage managers, and hotel and travel professionals are expected to open in the next few years. Tourism and culinary careers are fantastic for anyone who loves working with people in a fast-paced environment. Dedication, the right training, and a bold attitude are ingredients for success. That's why the hospitality industry is our career play of the game.
Well, I tell you, how are things going over there in social media? I see a lot of likes on Facebook.
A lot of likes. You know, Grace is going around taking pictures of some of the crazy costumes. So you know what? Go online, go on to Facebook, like us, and tell us which costume you like the most.
And they can also tweet, I think.
That's right. Are you tweeting yet?
I'm not tweeting just yet. I'm working on that. Maybe after the championship's over. I'm not sure. We're getting ready for the second half of this big 5A girls championship game. We're back with the second half, the final 16 minutes, right after this timeout, live from Macon Coliseum, live on GPB, and like us on Facebook. Welcome back to GPB's broadcast of the GHSA Boys and Girls State Championship. Time now for the second half of the girls' 5A state championship game. Let's check in with Raven Tirado. Raven?
Hey, thanks, Mark. Coach, that was kind of a rough first half. You can't seem to gain the momentum, the right rhythm. What was your message to the girls to gain some redemption?
We have to let our defense dictate what we do on offense, and we got to pick up the defensive intensity. That's what I told them back there. And we're going to come out. We're okay. Come out the second half and do a better job playing defense.
All right, Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
All right, guys, you heard it.
All right, Raven, let's see if Coach Breedlove is going to get her way. And, Sean, I guess when you look at the scope of this first half, it's turnovers and fouls when we get to the highlights.
Well, here's the thing, a combined 28 turnovers and 19 fouls. Not a good, solid first half of good basketball. There were some key shots being made, a lot of steals, a lot of deflections. But in order for this game to improve, to get better, both teams have to protect the basketball, continue to hit outside shots like Martin, but you have to stay solid and stay focused. You just can't lose your composure.
Martin, the only player in double figures for either squad, finishing with 10 for Southwest DeKalb. Tashi Thompson and Clarissa Weaver led Miller Grove with 6 each. And there's Deja Clay with the 2. Let's take a look at our first half stats brought to us by our friends at the Georgia Farm Bureau. What sticks out here?
Again, we talked about the turnovers there, John. Turnovers, 28 turnovers there in the first half. Both teams have to improve, slow down. But as Coach Breedlove talked about it, get better with your defense, protect the basket, and get easy points there in transition. Simplify the process.
Miller Grove, field goals 8 of 22. Southwest DeKalb, 7 of 21. The rebounding edge to Miller Grove, 21 to 13. Stats provided by West Georgia Technical College, a unit of the Technical College System of Georgia. Thanks again to our friends at Georgia Farm Bureau for giving us a look at the halftime stats. So then if you're Kathy Walton, is it more of the same except less turnovers, maybe?
That's exactly right, John. More the same with the focus and the drive and the determination. Cut down on their turnovers. And let's see if we can actually get a good W here tonight.
Miller Grove and Southwest DeKalb, you look at that magic number, 60.
Yeah.
And that seems to be the magic number to get everything done. Miller Grove, you know, you're playing in the 50s. Everything's fine on one side of it. The only team to clear 60. Got the Duke on the other side. So let's see what happens here in the second half. Will either team come close, or will this be a game in the 50s? Shot off the back of the rim, no good. Southwest DeKalb fighting for it off the rebound. Nephi Udofia and Dysa Alexander alternating possession, keeps it going from left to right.
Yeah, Coach Martin came out of the halftime and tried to attack Weaver, trying to pick up that extra foul, isolating her and Martin down low. Martin just didn't finish.
Marissa Weaver, Sarai Blissett, each with 3 fouls for Miller Grove. Something to keep an eye on, having both pick up a quick fourth, and a big collision there. Looks like it's going to be a foul on Tashi Thompson. And it looks like Thompson got the worst of the collision, but she got called for the foul.
John, you're exactly right. But you know, I'm starting now to be impressed, John, here by Deja Alexander, the freshman guard here for Southwest DeKalb, is doing a good job of controlling the game. Turnover there, side out of bounds. Hopefully she'll capitalize and pick it back up.
Trying to find a bounce pass inside. Looks like we're coming back the other way. Out of bounds to Southwest DeKalb. Yet another turnover for Miller Grove.
Well, we're starting off with turnovers. John, that may be the primary focus here going in the second half. Who can have the least amount of turnovers? Looks like we are going to have a lot.
And can take advantage of the ones coming from the other way. The 19th turnover for Miller Grove. And
turnover.
The 13th turnover for Southwest DeKalb. Most of the time, Sean, I know that you like to use the word turnover when it comes to a breakfast food, but not when it's 32 times mentioned in the first 17 minutes.
Yeah, this morning I asked my Amit, turn it over, turn it over, turn it over. Didn't think it was going to be a basketball game statement as well, too.
Hack on the inside. Looks like Davion Wingate's going to get called for the foul. Let's take another look at it. On the inside is Miller Grove tried to...
The high-low pass. It's a strong, solid foul there by Richardson.
Shaquan to Durden with the backflip.
Yeah.
Landing easily. Foul on Ariel Walker. Her first. Wingate's going to take the seat for Southwest DeKalb, and they're going to swap out Deja Clay for Davion Wingate.
Yeah, Deja Clay, probably the most important piece to that first half run there by Southwest DeKalb with her size, strength, and her hustle plays allow Southwest DeKalb to have a four-point lead.
Shaquan to Durden, only a 23% free throw shooter coming into the game, misses that one as we go 1 minute gone here, third quarter, and out of bounds to Miller Grove.
Miller Grove have to make shots. Two free throws you miss. Multiple opportunities. Turnovers. They've got to capitalize what the game gives them.
Miller Grove drive on the inside without the basketball, dished off. Misses everything, but Miller Grove comes back with it. Blocked. Big block that time by Maya Crowder.
Yeah, she did a great job of contesting that long shot. With a nice forceful swipe.
I believe that will not be entering into my paint, is what I think she was saying with that.
Yes.
Miller Grove basketball coming off the elbow, almost knocked away by Deja Clay. Pass to the edge, and looks like they're going to call a foul before the ball got knocked out of bounds.
Now, you talked about solid play with this, with what's going on with both teams. I think there's so much energy. At the same time, both teams like to play with their defense and score in transition. This game now, John, has become a half-court game, and now there's so much in the paint where they're forcing bad outside shots just like that. So not a clean game with both teams. Just a lot of energy and excitement.
Foul on Alexander before this particular possession. A lot of jousting going on in the paint. It seems like it's almost three different ball games. In the first quarter, it was called very tightly.
Exactly.
Second quarter, they kind of let things go a little bit. Third quarter, they might be letting things go a little more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just, you know, you got to let the players decide the championship game tonight, John. You can't allow the officials to do it. Unfortunately, the way the players are playing with so much swatting, so many fouls being actively decided here on the court, unfortunately, the officials do have to blow the whistle.
Durden back to the free throw line for Miller Grove. Misses the first again. You saw Dice Alexander getting some advice from Kathy Walton. Second free throw by Durden. He's too strong off the back of the rim. Southwest DeKalb with the rebound, trying to get out of traffic with it. Turnover. Let's see if anything comes of it. Rims out. No good. Rebound Southwest DeKalb. Fought for, knocked out of bounds by Miller Grove. It'll stick with the Lady Panthers.
You know, John, and I hate to say this right now. I think both teams, shooting is something you may want to back up and talk about. Let's talk about just the athletes on the court. There's so many good athletes that they're using their athletic ability, matching up person for person.
And a foul as Darsane DeShazer was trying to bring it up the floor.
Yeah, you see
foul
what Coach Breedlove just frustrated knowing that Durden didn't need to make that foul, especially in the open court. Move your feet, be patient on defense. Don't create early mistakes, and that was an unnecessary foul needed there by Durden.
Durden will sit. Sharika Brown into the ball game. That was Durden's first foul. 6:15 to go, third quarter. Southwest DeKalb still with a four-point lead off the glass. Too hard, rebound, no good. Third chance, maybe Deja Clay wanted it. Going to call alternating possession. It's going to go Miller Grove's way.
Yeah, both teams is playing with so much emotion right now, John. So much energy. I'm not even able to knock down just an easy, simple point-blank range layup.
Is there something as simple as trying too hard?
I don't think they're trying too hard, John. I just think that there's just so much emotion out there. There's just so much emotion out there that the only thing they can do is exert energy. So you may be right. Yes.
And that's what I mean. It's because you're so wrapped up in what you're trying to do, it's almost like you're trying too hard and forcing issues. Basket is good that time.
Oh, my gosh. Chinese mark. Nice athletic move. She finished with a nice soft left-handed jump hook there 5 feet outside the paint.
Martin now with 12. for Southwest DeKalb, 12 of their 26. Rebound off the Miller Grove miss. And a tie-up, and it looks like they're going to call Tashi Thompson for the foul.
Yeah. Not the kind of foul you wanted there, Tashi Thompson. I guess in the open court. Here's Martin, using her athletic ability. Great drive. Nice soft kiss with the left hand off the glass.
Left-handers like to see left-handers do that kind of
thing. Oh, my gosh, but, you know, she's just a special player, being able to use both hands to be successful on the offensive end.
The Shaves are looking for a college three and hits it.
Hey, that's the first open look anyone between both teams have had all night long. She stepped up, knocked down the three.
29-20, coming up on 5 minutes to go here, third quarter. Miller Grove rushes up a shot, calls the miss. Ball goes out of bounds to Miller Grove. Yet another Southwest DeKalb turnover. They're 17th in the ball game. Let's take a look at the DeShazer three again.
Oh, she just steps in with nice arc, good rotation. Swish.
Looks like Renee Breedlove's going to call a timeout to kind of think things through. It's going to be a full.
Yeah, she's got to get control of her team, John. Calm them down. Too much emotion. You know, they've never been in this type of situation where they have to play from behind, and the hole is starting to get wider and wider and wider as it's a 9-point lead here in the third quarter.
You think about Miller Grove's losses. They started the year with a loss to St. Francis, lost to Stevenson in a region game back just after Thanksgiving, lost to Columbia, the AAA champs, by 5 close to Christmas, then lost to Tucker in a region game in the middle of January before losing to Southwest DeKalb. It's like they're averaging a loss a month. But once again, Southwest DeKalb, the team that got to 60 in these games.
Right.
That was that magic number.
Exactly.
And there's your Southwest DeKalb resume on the quick side. 3 straight titles, 08, 09, 2010. And they've made the finals in 5 of the last 6 seasons. Says a lot about what Kathy Walton's been able to do for the Panthers.
Well, John, you know, as we talked about again on the broadcast, it's very hard to beat a team 4 times in a row. And Southwest DeKalb won that 4th meeting there in the Region Conference Championship. It's really harder to beat a team 4 out of 5 times. So now Southwest DeKalb has the advantage right now with an 8-9 point lead in the third quarter. Can they keep it? Can they hold it together and not allow Miller Grove to pick up some type of run of momentum?
Third quarter field goal numbers. Miller Grove 0 for 5 from the floor here in the third. In the first 3 minutes, Southwest DeKalb has hit 2 of their 5 shots. And it's just, you know, the word that comes to mind is just tenacious.
Yeah, yeah, the Southwest DeKalb block. Watch every loose ball. Watch every big ball. They're the first ones on the floor. They're contesting shots. They're going in and taking the ball off the rebounds. They're the ones that's been the aggressive team so far.
And you remember Shaquan Durden also had those 4 opportunities for free throws. Missed all 4.
Yes, she did. And that hurt. Could have easily been a 5-point game.
So now coming out of the timeout, Miller Grove will inbound. And it's going to be Katie Hunt. And it's picked off, and coming down the other way for the easy 2 is Ariel Walker.
Yeah, looks like Southwest DeKalb now in their defensive rhythm, getting into the passing lanes and getting steals.
Katie Hunt double teamed right near midcourt, dribbles out of traffic, dribbles out of a really tough spot, pulls up for the jumper too hard. Miller Grove comes up with the rebound. And they're going to try it again. Southwest DeKalb on a 7-0 run. We'll see if Miller Grove can do anything about it. No, the miss there in the paint. Ball's out of bounds, heading the other way.
Yeah, Miller Grove, John, not playing aggressive right now. Definitely playing on their heels. Southwest DeKalb being very aggressive and taking it to the hoop. Good 2 points there for Ariel Walker.
Walker's first 2 points of the ball game. Miller Grove trying to do pressure, tried to have a token 2-1-2, then they pull it back after the inbound. Tynese Martin bringing it over the half court line. That's a lot of trust in a young athlete.
Yes, it is.
Got that. Got a whistle. Let's see where the whistle's going to come from. On the joust, Soraya Bissett. That's her 4th. Deja Clay was way out, and Blissett had to work her way around Clay, and it didn't quite work for her 4th foul, and she's staying in with 4 until, looks like, next dead ball situation. Blissett is going to get swapped out for her. Walker, dish, jumper, rims out, no good. Deja Clay tries to come down with a rebound, can't quite do it.
Deja Clay is playing really, really good, relentless now on the offensive glass. Even though she did step out of bounds, she's getting her hands on all missed baskets, all deflections, all steals. I mean, Deja Clay right now being the most important player in this game for Southwest DeKalb.
There's Bissett sitting with her four fouls. Clarissa Weaver with three for Miller Grove. And not having either one of them in the lineup is really hurting Renee Breedlove right now. Shot no good. Block coming down in transition. Walker looking to pass inside and try to force something. Got a foul call on Miller Grove.
Yeah, Southwest DeKalb attacking in transition. Miller Grove, all five players not getting back, forming the wall defensively, but taking the basket. And Walker able to come up with a chance to get two hit the free throw line.
Third foul on Tashi Thompson. 6 points and three fouls. Walker using the glass.
She called it in her mind.
That's what
she called
it for.
She called it.
39% foul shooter on the year, gets the first with a little assistance from the plexi and gets the second one, no problem.
Yeah, great stroke, good smooth rotation.
Southwest DeKalb leads out to 13, 33-20 under 4 minutes to go. We're past the halfway point here in the third quarter from the Macon Centerplex and the Macon Coliseum here on GPB. Championship weekend of the 2013 GHSA Basketball Championships. Back rim, no good. In transition, Walker all alone, catching it from behind. Look out, intentional foul call. Wasting no time, they call the intentional foul on Tashi Thompson. It's going to be her fourth. And this could be a huge call down the line.
You're exactly right, John. Here's Martin advancing the ball up the court. There to Walker.
And wasting no time.
No time exactly.
With the crossed forearm.
Well, John, both teams have been jawing at one another. So when a foul like that, they have to get control underneath the game, over the game. So that's what you call the intentional foul. That was a good call there by the official.
Renee Breedlove saying they're saying that Thompson was going for the ball, and obviously you see that she doesn't agree. First free throw was missed by Walker. Second was made. And with that free throw, we're going to take a break. Key moment with the intentional foul called. Southwest DeKalb's lead is now 34-20. Big defensive presence on one end, coming back with the big jumpers and using the glass on the other. 3:35 for the third. Southwest DeKalb rolling here on GPB. Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex. 3:35 for the third. Southwest DeKalb up 34-20. And we know that these two teams are playing for the championships. Let's look at the road to the championships here in Macon, brought to us by our friends at Georgia's EMCs, lighting the way and leading the way. Wins over Sprayberry by three, beating Villarica by 31. Stevenson by six, and a nail biter against Forest Park, 43-41, to get to the game tonight against Miller Grove. And on the flip side, Miller Grove, your defending champs, trying to get themselves out of a 14-point hole, beating Pope by 18, Alatoona, the Lady Bucks by 13, beating Tucker, region rival there, by 10, and then stifling Effingham County, 49-23. Effingham County didn't score, what, in the last 15 minutes of that game from
the
floor?
Yeah, and see, Effingham County not accustomed to that type of region play basketball there by Miller Grove, just, you know, using their strength and ability, but now being matched up with Southwest DeKalb. Southwest DeKalb, John, has kind of learned after five times now playing them, have learned the good, the bad, the ugly, and how to attack Miller Grove, and they're using it now to their advantage tonight.
Miller Grove has missed their last 13 shots from the floor. They're 0 for 11 here in the third.
Well, John, every shot's been contested. There has not been an open look there for Miller Grove. Southwest DeKalb is doing a great job as contesting shots and rebounding.
Shot blocked there by Miller Grove. Southwest DeKalb now 3 for 8, 37.5% here in the third, dribbling down the floor. Almost a steps call could have been made. Their shot missed, no good. Trying it in, finally a bucket for Miller Grove. Katie Hunt.
Yeah, Katie Hunt did a great job of just finishing there on the missed basket.
Steal off the inbounds and a foul on the dive, trying to save it back for Southwest DeKalb. And here's how they finally got the deuce on the board here in the third.
Yeah, just finishing there off the missed basket there by Durden. Katie Hunt trying to put this team on her back.
Katie Hunt now with six, getting her first bucket here in the third quarter. 3:15 to go here in the third. Southwest DeKalb. third on Katie Hunt for Miller Grove. It looks like there's a discussion by the officials as to the where and the how to reintroduce. There's a numbers discussion going on in there. And here we go with the explanation.
Let's see what happens here.
23 with the push.
That was on Martin.
Okay, so they're calling Martin for the foul instead of Hunt. That'll be her first. So Hunt stays at two fouls. And that's no lie. 29 total fouls. We had 19 at the half. We've had 10 here in the third quarter.
Yeah, John, we still got over close to 3 minutes left in the third quarter, a little bit over that. So a lot of basketball to be played.
This would be a tough game at Memorial Stadium in Region 6 during football season.
Yes, it would. A lot of contact. A lot of contact.
Ball out of bounds. Southwest DeKalb will get to reintroduce with 3:10 to go here in the third. No help on the inbound. Dangerous place to put it. Calling a timeout. Looks like they gave it to Tynese Martin. So a smart idea as she was falling out of bounds to call the timeout. Looks like they gave it to her, but they did. And Kathy Walton's going to call a 30 on it.
Yeah.
And when it comes to being a part of Georgia Public Broadcasting, there are plenty of ways to do it. You can text GPB to 85944 to show your support. You get to donate $10 to GPB to keep these fine kids and these fine shows on the air. Remember to reply yes to confirm your donation. Standard data and text message rates apply. A one-time charge of $10 will be added to your phone bill. Support these great games and great kids. Thank you for your text donation. Once again, text GPB to 85944. A lot of ways to stay active in the process to make sure that we can continue to bring these kinds of programs to you every year. And that's definitely one of those ways. 3:09 for the third. Southwest DeKalb clamping down on Miller Grove here in the third quarter. The advantage is 12. Southwest DeKalb with a long pass backwards, intercepted by Miller Grove. And it looks like there's another foul call on Maya Crowder this time.
Yeah, John, right now the game is not being as smooth as we were accustomed to there in the second quarter. Both teams trying to show their skills defensively with reaching and hacking and a lot of fouls. The officials are a little bit frustrated with the play, you can tell. So we definitely need to start cleaning this thing up so we can finish out the evening with good solid play.
Davian Wingate in, Ariel Walker out for Southwest DeKalb. Miller Grove 1-for-13 from the floor in this quarter alone. After being 8-for-22 in the first half, shot up, no good. Rebound picked up, knocked out of bounds by Imani Richardson, Miller Grove, and it's going to stay with Southwest DeKalb.
We generally saw something, and this is something that Miller Grove is doing. After missed shots, they're going to trap the rebound, especially underneath the basket, which is making it very hard for Southwest DeKalb. And within a 10-second frame, they just used two unnecessary timeouts. They definitely didn't need that.
Let's take a look at the rematch last year. 46-39 was the final. You saw Southwest DeKalb's defense turn into offense, and Southwest DeKalb, after being down early, make their way back into the ball game. But once again, Miller Grove asserting themselves on their way to get that first championship, working it from the inside and the outside. Renee Breedlove getting that first championship right there. 46-39, your final score. And the Wolverines, the Lady Wolverines, get to join Charm White when it comes to being referred to as state champs last year at the arena at Gwinnett Center.
Yeah, Coach Breedlove just trying to keep her girls under control, keep their composure, keep the fight going with inside them, but they have to be smart in these last 3 minutes in the third quarter.
And apparently also Coach Breedlove got a warning from the official, so I'll have to keep an eye on that as well. Third quarter field goal numbers, Miller Grove 1 of 14, Southwest DeKalb 3 for 8. Katie Hunt trying to work the perimeter, ball knocked away, and it looks like they're going to call a kick. Dice Alexander would have had the floor to herself if she hadn't kicked it. Let's take a look.
Trying to do the exchange and the weave. Don't know if that was a kickball. That was just good basketball. Great defense there by the freshman.
Now, when it comes to a kick, does it have to be in 10, or does it just the motion of the ball hitting the foot count?
It depends on what part of the foot it hits. And right then, I thought the ball actually hit the top part of the lower part of the knee. And just skidded down the court. The official saw it differently and called the kickball.
All right, let's take a look. All right, let's describe this for me and figure out what
we're looking at. Here's his change. And I don't think she actually advanced it down the court. So sometimes, depends on the official, depends on their eye, they could call that a kickball, or they could just call it as a loose ball and advance down the court, let the play just resume.
Looks like a kick save, called a kickball. Southwest DeKalb with the basketball, trying to drive on the paint, too short. Rebound picked up by Nephi Yadofia, and looks like Miller Grove's going to try to come out with it. Coming up close to 2:10 to go for the third. Double team in the corner. Play, ball hits the turf. Yadofia trying to back away in. No good.
Here's that trap underneath the basket.
And those Wingate. Shaquan to Dirt and get the tie-up.
Yeah. So underneath the basket is a hard place to actually catch the ball. Whether it's a made shot, a missed shot, or a turnover, there's a trap by Southwest DeKalb. Loose ball.
Yadofia.
And there's a trap again. There's a trap underneath the basket.
Issues on the inbound. It's a 5-second call, and we're coming back the other way with it. 20th turnover for Southwest DeKalb right there.
Just a game, John, just being played in spurts. No one again. We're back to no rhythm. So the team's right now just in some type of disarray out here on the court, not having even good smooth basketball being played.
Katie Hunt picking up the inbound. There's Clarissa Weaver. We have to keep an eye on her and her foul situation. Off the glass, no good. Weaver with the rebound, counted, and the foul. And that's the presence that Renee Breedlove was looking for on the inside. The foul troubles kept Lissette out of it, and Weaver in the ball game finally gets something done there.
Yeah, just great opportunity there. Just get the ball, rebounded at your peak. Great finish here for and one.
Maya Crowder picking up her third flat foul. Clarissa Weaver completes a three-point play. We're under double digits. It's a nine-point game, 34-25. Down court, setting up the offense. Turnaround jumper is going to be short. Is short. Rebound picked up by Miller Grove. Coming up on 100 seconds and a big battle for it with Maya Crowder. Looks like it was Grove and Shaquan to Durden.
It was. And Crowder just a little too strong down there for Durden. And
was able to come out with possession error. Coach Breedlove's going to take another 30 to talk about it because she's gotten it from 14 down to 9. 101 seconds to go here in the third. Mm-hmm. And so now she's kind of getting things pieced together, kind of working things down the line.
Right.
Taking a possession at a time. You get something here, it's down to 7. And that way you're trying to just narrow the game down a little bit by getting it as close as you can by the fourth quarter.
Well, what's happening, John, you see Miller Grove now starting to fight with the same focus that Southwest DeKalb has had pretty much the entire game. Now starting to match the intensity, something we didn't think we would need to talk about tonight. Miller Grove now matching the intensity for Southwest DeKalb. As a result, Miller Grove now cut to that 14-point lead. It's a 9-point game here with a buck and 41 to go.
Third quarter turnover numbers, Miller Grove with 7, Southwest DeKalb with 5. Overall numbers, Southwest DeKalb with 20. Miller Grove with 24 turnovers in this game. 44 turnovers for both teams, and we're not even through the third quarter yet. Token pressure on the inbound by Southwest DeKalb. Weaver with it in the backcourt, needs some help to bring it through. Shaquanda Durden brings it across the half-court line. Looking inside, back door, Udofia gets the two.
Hey, great pass there up top. Weaver been able to see over her weak shoulder for the high low and the finish.
We're down to seven now for Miller Grove. Southwest DeKalb leading 34-27, coming up on a minute 15 for the third. Right in front of us, looks like Katie Hunt got called for the foul as Tiny Smart was trying to bring it up over. Miller Grove on a 7-0 run.
Here's a high-low pass. The pass goes to the high post. Nice pass over top. Down low to Udofia.
Third for Katie Hunt this time. Udofia with the bucket. Tiny Smart coming to the line. Had 10 at the half. Only two. Here in the third quarter, misses the front end of the 1-1.
Yeah, Hunt had a chance to actually capitalize on something special.
And the jump out missed defensively. Long jumper, no good. Fought for once again. Call alternating possession. Southwest DeKalb, aerial walk.
See, John, there's so much activity out here. If you're an official, you just can't call everything. You have to call the obvious. So, you know, they're letting the players play a little bit more. It may look a little helter-skelter to those of you at home, but this is a very, very athletic game played between two competitive teams.
Imani Richardson back in for Miller Grove. Coming up the four for Southwest DeKalb. Isa Alexander driving into the paint.
Nice move.
This is the layup, knocked out of bounds.
Hey, that was a nice move. Isa Alexander being able to drive coast to coast. Had a chance to finish, but that was a nice move on her behalf getting to the rim.
Just take a look at her going, coach.
And see, she's just a freshman. Look at how she gets up there, uses her body. Just not able to capitalize, but she's got a bright future. Keep working hard. Good things are going to happen to her down the road.
51.3 and counting here in the third quarter. Miller Grove down by as many as 14. Cut that in half to seven. Pass inside, knocked out. Trying again with the runner, no good. Rebound, no good. Partially deflected. Third time deflected out. Fourth time up and in. And are they going to give it to Weaver with the continuation? And they are.
Yes, they did, John. Yes, they did. So now the momentum now changing and shifting over to Miller Grove. Good block. But you got to come up with the ball. You just can't block it. You knocked it back to the offense. Weaver was able to finish with the two off the glass. Can she complete the three-point play?
55% free throw shooter coming in. There you see Weaver signed with UNC Asheville. Averaging 11 points a game. 50% shooter from the floor this season.
And see, John, watch this. There's going to be pressure here after this free throw. Make or miss. Watch the pressure by Miller Grove. There it is. Face guard. Good pressure on the ball. Here comes a trap. Good defense. So Miller Grove now moving a step quicker than it did, John, the first part of the game. Now on a 10-0 run because of their defense and their energy.
30.6 to go for the third. Miller Grove was down 14, now down four. Spinning out was Dysa Alexander trying to work her way to the bucket. Looks like she just spun out and blew a tire.
Well, it did look that way, John. From this angle, looked like she got tripped. Official didn't call that. Those were the calls that were happening there in the first part of the game. Yeah, she did trip over Carisha Brown's foot. No call by the official. Turnover going now towards Miller Grove.
Questioning the no call. 20 seconds to go here for the third. Miller Grove trying to cut the advantage from 14 down to maybe two. Scrum on the floor. Southwest DeKalb comes out with it. Down to 10 seconds. Drive too hard. Martin too hard. Coming back the other way. It's Imani Richardson. Richardson out of control. They got a whistle. Let's see what we're going to call the foul here. Is it going to be on Alexander? It's going to be Alexander's fourth, and so this will be a situation that Southwest DeKalb's going to have to pay.
Hey, transition basketball, that's just a freshman not making a smart decision defensively. Protect the basket. They don't need a foul there, especially with 2.7 on the clock.
There's Alexander, the 5'7 freshman. Monty Richardson to the line, gets the first.
Then we're down to a three-point game here with 2.7 to go in the third quarter. Miller Grove just now showing a little sense of toughness.
One for two, 33% on the line, only 18 free throw attempts coming into this game for the season for Richardson. Makes one of two. Miller Grove at one point was down 14. They've scored 11 in a row. 24 minutes down, 8 minutes to go to determine the girls' Class 5A champion. Will Miller Grove repeat or Southwest DeKalb get another one? Answers coming up. Welcome back, Macon Coliseum, Macon Centerplex. Start of the last 8 minutes to determine the girls' Class 5A champion. Raven Tirado over on the sidelines. Raven, what's the word?
Yeah, John, I'm over here on the Southwest DeKalb bench. It's a very calm, collective group. They're going over plays. They're not panicking. They're focusing. They're just doing what they need to do out on the court to try to come out with a win.
Thank you very much, Raven. Third quarter numbers from the field. Southwest DeKalb, 3 of 13. They missed their last seven. Miller Grove, 4 for 21 in the quarter. They missed their first 11. Finished the quarter 4 for 10. Third quarter was a case of runs for both sides. Southwest DeKalb had a 10-0 run. Miller Grove responded with an 11-0 run that they're still on right now.
Yeah, John, here's a stat that I'm really focused on now. Miller Grove, 6 of 14 from the free throw line. Southwest DeKalb, 13 of 19 from the free throw line. It's going to come down who can make those shots there at 15 feet and in.
Start of the final 8 minutes. Will Miller Grove repeat his chance? Will Southwest DeKalb and Kathy Walden add another one to their mantle? Inbounding Katie Hunt. Give and go with Clarissa Weaver. Hunt will cycle the offense 5 seconds in. Tashi Thompson up top. Hunt looking to drive. Pulls up off the window. Rims out no good. Udofia was fighting for it with Katie Hunt, but Hunt got the rebound in the bucket.
See, Hunt was so determined to get that, make that play, if not make the shot, get the offensive rebound, and then she actually came up with the 2 points. That was a great job, a lot of effort there on Hunt's behalf.
Tynese Martin trying to inbound. A lot of difficulty, and as you say, coming off of the made basket, Miller Grove looking to press. A lot of wide open space here. Baseline jumper looks like it was hard, and it was too much. Off the back of the rim, fought for out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Southwest DeKalb.
Well, Southwest DeKalb initially, John, took the fight. Now they're starting to take the fight now from Miller Grove because Miller Grove is now hitting, using all their punches to actually try to finish out the game.
Long loop over the top, dangerous pass, but it ends up coming in for Southwest DeKalb. Runner for the two is Ariel Walker.
Yeah, great drive to the basket, knowing that the trees down low weren't going to foul her. Great finish there on Southwest DeKalb.
Walker now with 7 for Southwest DeKalb. Lead 36-33, 1 minute into the fourth quarter. And that ended a 13-0 run for Miller Grove. Tashi Thompson way out, getting instructions from Coach Breedlove. And looks like Renee Breedlove's going to call a 30. She was not happy with what she was seeing out there on the floor.
Well, John, the two possessions before that, John, they tried to loop around and get a baseline drive. And defensively, they cannot play El Matador defense, not allowing the offense to come through without any type of contest on the layups or the shots. Coach Breedlove now is going to coach the team, watch for an interesting set, possibly a high-low action to try to get an easy path to the basket and then set their press defense.
Two timeouts left for Miller Grove here in the game. Southwest DeKalb and Kathy Walton have 3. And that's an interesting question. You see how active the Southwest DeKalb cheerleaders are. I wish I had a band to direct. You know what I'm saying?
A band to direct?
Yeah.
Come on, John, a band?
Yeah, I directed the band during football season.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, here, John, I got something for you.
Uh-oh.
My name is Sean. I'm here with John. We are making, we're in Macon, Georgia to see who wants to be number one. We have lots of basketball and other programs, you see. So go to Facebook and like GPB. How about that? That's your band, John.
Yeah, we talk about some of the great poets of all time. Edgar Allan Poe.
Oh, wow.
William Shakespeare.
Exactly.
Sean Golden's not one of those two.
Oh,
gentlemen.
I'm not. LL Cool J, LL Junebug, whoever.
LL Junebug.
Oh, that's an old school. I'm
big bucket
sucker.
There.
Great bucket.
Big bucket, Tashi Thompson to get back on the board for Miller Grove. Miller Grove coming back with it. It's Katie Hunt. Katie Hunt rims out with the bucket fought for underneath.
See the trap.
Southwest DeKalb comes out.
There's that trap, and now getting out of the trap. What can happen now? Can Martin make a great play?
Tashi Thompson knocks it out of bounds, but let's see what tied the game up. That's a clean college three right there.
Yes, it was. Nice three. Bad broken down defense.
So everything is back to where it was when it started.
Exactly right.
25 minutes and 38 seconds have resolved absolutely nothing. We're tied at 36. Inbound for Southwest DeKalb. Tynese Martin. Turnaround off the glass. No good. Nefi Udofia got the rebound, and she was tied up by Maya Crowder. Southwest DeKalb will get possession.
Yeah, here's a great chance for us to really see what can happen with an experienced squad like Miller Grove versus an unexperienced squad like Southwest DeKalb. Southwest DeKalb look like they can maintain their composure, but I'm really impressed with what Coach Breedlove has done. Molded her seniors together, and they fought back from a 14-point deficit.
Third tie of the game now at 36, foul on Nefi Udofia. That's going to be her first. Gavion Wingate to the line for Southwest DeKalb. First free throws up and good.
Good shot, good shot, great shot.
The Wingate pedigree, the name's familiar. David Wingate, Georgetown. So Gavion has had basketball exposure for a long time. Second leading scorer for Southwest DeKalb, averaging 10 points a game. 58% from the line coming into the game, makes the second.
Nice stroke. She stepped up, sophomore going up, stepping up to the line, knocking down two free throws.
38-36, Southwest DeKalb. The high looping pass gets it into the offensive zone. There's your free throw numbers. Look at the disparity, 15 of 21 for Southwest DeKalb in the game. 10-point passing, bringing it down. Nice spin move, but blocked out of bounds. It's going to stay with Southwest DeKalb. Ariel Walker with some good move.
Now, John, this is what we call in the street. That's a million-dollar move, but a $5 finish. Great block, good help on the defense. Again, Southwest DeKalb capitalizing on the failed defensive mistakes there by Miller Grove. Bostic with the two.
As it gets saved out of bounds, here's your inbounds. Really quick, just look at this. Quick turn, spin move with the right hand.
Yeah, you got to be ready. You got to play before the ball is even handed to the official, and to your teammate, because you got to be in defensive position and have a presence there on the court.
Maya Crowder with the deuce. Southwest DeKalb now up four as we approach 5.5 to go regulation. Shot too hard. Crowder with the rebound on the inside. She's going to give it to Davian Wingate, who will bring it up the floor.
Yeah, definitely not the shots that you want if you coach Breedlove, because they've taken a few contested shots, which have not been something good to help out the team.
Wingate drives into the paint, gets it blocked by Carissa Weaver, coming back out. It's Miller Grove, and on the floor, a three-player scrum. They're going to call alternate possession, and it's going to stay with Miller Grove.
You know, both teams are trying to leave it out on the court. A lot of heart, a lot of hustle.
Take a look at the scrum on the floor and the end result.
Yeah, just both players going down, all three players going down to the count. A lot of times you hit your head on that hardwood. The hardwood doesn't give, John, so definitely give credit to Tashi Thompson for being tough and getting up and finishing out the play.
Sandy Shazer involved for Southwest DeKalb. 5 minutes to go regulation. Southwest DeKalb up 40-36. Three-pointer misses everything. And it's going to go back the other way. Miller Grove saying that the ball was tipped. Officials didn't see it that way. So Tynese Martin's going to inbound, looking for someone to inbound it to. Gives to Crowder. Crowder's probably going to get pinned in the corner. Give to Wingate. Wingate crosses over half court. Three on two. If she's got it down, they'll paint with the easy two.
God. She attacked that rim very confidently throughout the fast break. That was really good of her, breaking the press and attacking the rim.
Game was tied at 36. It's now 42-36. Southwest DeKalb has scored the last 6 points. Ball blocked in the paint. Off the attempt at the pass, Durden throws it up against the glass. They're going to call steps and go the other way.
And see Southwest DeKalb doing a great job with the defensive pressure, but Miller Grove playing uncharacteristically. Here we go, attacking the rim out of the fast break.
Durden let Wingate go by.
And Durden's got to do a better job defensively. She's playing out of control emotionally. Play within your game. Move your feet. Cut the ball off. Stop the penetration because you are the back part of the press. It's very important.
51 turnovers in the game. Miller Grove has 29 of them. Southwest DeKalb is going to call a full timeout. Kathy Walton's going to talk about it with a 6-point lead with 4:25 to go. So let's take a look at what happened the last time Southwest DeKalb won a championship. Miss Georgia basketball. It was a busy night for Kayla Lewis. You see her get a lot of action. You saw her make the first bucket, work it down the floor. And then you're going to see her pull up for three right here. When you get one, two, and three baskets, you end up beating Northwest Whitfield and Emily True, who had a great run. The Lady Bruins making their way through. 65-45, your final score. Kayla Lewis had a big night for Kathy Walton, winning in 2008, 2009, and 2010. That was the third in a row. And she's trying for a fourth title here with Southwest DeKalb. And she's now 4 minutes and 25 seconds away from doing that with a 6-point lead. They've made the finals in five of the last six seasons with a rematch tonight, being a rematch from last year's championship game with Miller Grove.
Yeah, John. You know, again, we talked about it in the beginning, just to remind everyone at home, this is the fifth matchup this season with both of these teams. Miller Grove now has a 3-1 edge this season with games. The last time they met was in the conference tournament. Southwest DeKalb came back with the W.
Southwest DeKalb is the only one in this group to score 60 and get the win. Miller Grove's played it in the 50s the entire time and won. Into the paint. Nice pinpoint passing off the glass, up and in. Southwest DeKalb, Maya Crowder for two.
Yeah, that's great pass there by Sharika Brown. Receiving the pass up top from Hunt.
Dribbling, nice bounce pass. Durden thought about it. Then she's circling back into the paint. Pass high off the glass with the shot, no good. And it looks like a frustration foul might be called on Sharika Brown this time.
With John, you're exactly right. Just here's Martin up top with the ball. Excuse me, that's Thompson up on the top of the ball. Pass it to Brown. Bound. Pick it over.
Maya Crowder for the Deuce. Fourth quarter field goal numbers. Miller Grove 29%, 2 of 7. Southwest DeKalb 43%, 3 of 7. It's almost like scoring is being done in blocks.
Well, it is, John, because there's so much foul. You may have 10 to 20 seconds of good basketball, but then the foul comes in and slows down the pace and the tempo of the game.
Durden off the glass, short. Rebound picked up on the inside. Tynese Martin whistles. Let's see what happens here. Alternate possession, and we're heading back the other way with it.
Yes, yeah, becoming the free throw cycle now. Free throws, free throws, free throws. You know, coming down the court, here's Durden having a chance to finish with the two. The short-handed it. Again, our girl Martin there using her athletic ability to get the rebound.
Coming back down the other way. Shot was blocked and out of bounds as Wingate tried to drive. Deja Alexander coming into the ballgame. Darsane DeShazer will sit for Kathy Walton. With 3:40 to go regulation, Southwest DeKalb an 8-point lead. Southwest DeKalb had a 10-point run at one point. Miller Grove had a 13-point run at one point. Now Southwest DeKalb with an 8-point run now after the game was tied at 36. 3:34 to go and a whistle on the floor. Miller Grove's going to call a timeout, so there won't be any kind of a foul called. Renee Breedlove's going to call a 30. There's your 51 turnovers right there. Miller Grove with 29 of them. Miller Grove with now only one timeout remaining with the last 3:34 on the clock. Yeah, Southwest DeKalb has two left.
Well, John, those timeouts are going to be very important here down the stretch with 3 minutes and 34 seconds to go. Both teams want to secure the basketball. There are going to be a lot of dead ball situations. They're going to have to heave the pass so they can't get called for the five-second count.
Join in on the GPB Sports Chat during the game and during this entire weekend. Go to gpb.org and hit the live basketball banner at the top of the screen. Jump in with hundreds, nay, thousands of other high school basketball fans and chat about your favorite high school basketball team, whether it's one of these two or one of the ones that's playing this weekend or even if they're just watching. Let's hear from you, Georgia. Go to gpb.org/sports and get involved in that live basketball chat. Tell us what you like, what you don't like. And while you're at it, why don't you friend us on Facebook? You can critique Sean Golden and his poet writing ability. Miller Grove will retain possession with 3:21 to go regulation.
So, gentlemen, got a lot of basketball left. We mentioned 21 seconds, only an 8-point game. Still, a lot of basketball to be played.
Off the glass, too hard. Coming back out with it, Southwest DeKalb. Tysha Alexander, double teamed again is Wingate. Crowder, Tynese Martin. Ball knocked out of bounds by Clarissa Weaver. It's going to stay with Southwest DeKalb.
So, John, within the last 3 minutes of this game, you could have over 30 dead ball situations. If both teams are out of timeouts, these dead ball situations could be very important. Possibly costly turnovers there could happen.
Wingate gathering the inbound, guarded by Nefi Yadofia. By the end of the paint, high arcing shot off the glass and in.
Yeah, Richardson going in and showing her ability to create, finish it high and off the glass.
Wingate now with 6, 2:50 to go regulation. Southwest DeKalb on a 10-0 run. Off the glass, no good. 5-4 scrummed on the floor once again. Double clutch, no good. And it looks like Crowder might be called for the foul as Tashi Thompson tried to put up the shot.
Nice drive to the basket.
There's your scrum on the floor coming up with it. And there's Crowder trying to defend the shot there for Southwest DeKalb.
And see, this is who we haven't talked about all afternoon long, John, as much as we've talked about her in the beginning. Tashi Thompson, leader of the team in scoring at 13.9 points a game. She's got to do a better job of staying involved, getting involved in the offense, because they're going to need her scoring here down the stretch.
There's the numbers on Tashi Thompson, the 5'8 senior. Imani Richardson is in as Nefi Yadofia is out. She's made the two free throws to break up the 10-0 run for Southwest DeKalb. Miller Grove now down 8:46-38. And that run went for 3 minutes and 47 seconds.
But John, I'm going to show you something right now. Watch Martin. You have the baseline to run. She has not run the baseline yet after a made basket. She's trying to pass it from the spot. And that's a tough place to pass the ball. Each time she's done it, there's been a turnover, 2 turnovers in a row.
Richardson had it, lost it, foul on the floor, and it looks like, which way's the foul going to go? Foul on Miller Grove as Crowder was trying to go for the basketball.
See, Coach Walt needs to bring this team over, let Martin know you have the flexibility to run the court, run the baseline, and what she's not doing, she's standing still. There's a battle underneath after the inbound turnover. Good fight, girls. Great fight. That's the kind of fight you want to see, especially here in a championship setting.
And you see what Crowder was upset about. It's because it's her 5th foul. So Maya Crowder is done for the day. 5 points, fouling out at the 2:18 mark with Southwest DeKalb up 6. Tashi Thompson to the free throw line once more. First free throw's up and in.
Great stroke. She's got to step up to the plate. 2 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the game, John. She's got to be the one who puts her team on the back.
Thompson now with 12. Misses the second free throw. Rebound, Deja Clay. The lead is 5 for Southwest DeKalb. Break the early press. Wide open under the bucket was Darsan DeShazer. Wasn't seen. Deja Clay off the glass and in.
She was the one that actually kept them in the ball game the first half. Now trying to finish out the game with Clay finishing with 2.
Trying to come back the other way. Wraparound pass doesn't work. Southwest DeKalb with numbers. Wingate with the drive off the glass. No good. Rebound fought for underneath. Durden is fighting for it. For Miller Grove, Colorado alternating possession sticks with the Lady Wolverine.
Some of this competitive spirit out here on the court tonight between both teams is playing hard and aggressive. Now starting to play within a solid a sense of urgency here with 1:51 to go.
Southwest DeKalb pressing. Katie Hunt driving up. Ball hit the floor, goes out of bounds. Hunt can't believe it because it's going back to Southwest DeKalb at a turnover that they could not afford with 102 seconds to go regulation. Wide open off the inbound, Tynese Martin. No one guarding her for the touchdown pass. Easy two.
I see, John, that may have been the nail in the coffin right there. The Southwest DeKalb get behind the defense of Miller Grove. And Miller Grove only has 1 timeout left. They can't use it now.
Weaver for 2.
The clock.
And Southwest DeKalb is going to do Miller Grove a favor.
Yes, they are, John. Yes, they are. Don't understand that because the clock was in your favor. The 10-second rule from the official hadn't started there in the baseline because there was some type of a combination of connecting with the ball hit by Miller Grove.
With as many problems as Southwest DeKalb has had on the inbounds here in the fourth quarter, Kathy Walton probably wants to talk it through and talk about it.
Right.
Because Miller Grove had put three players in the past on the baseline.
Right.
Guarding to see if there was some kind of a numbers game.
Well, John, I talked about this about a few minutes ago. Martin is stationary on the baseline. She has the flexibility after a made basket to go move the base to run on the baseline. She hasn't done that the last four times. As a result, there has been a turnover. Now, hopefully, their coach is in the huddle. Coach Walton is telling her, Martin, you can run the baseline. You can move. Don't be stationary because we need you to actually hit the open person but take advantage of what the rules actually allow you to do. Run the baseline.
And for those who don't know, can you do it after a timeout situation, or is it a stationary thing now?
No, it's still. See, right now she's stationary. Could have been a dead ball, but just the offense of and the defense there, Miller Grove, just playing into frustration because of the turnover.
And that was that last basket with the touchdown pass that got us to this point.
So there's a signal. You have the baseline run. Quick foul.
Martin with a double-double after that particular basket that she scored. 14 points, 15 rebounds, leading Southwest DeKalb. She's the only player in double figures for Southwest DeKalb with 14. DeShazer has 8. Wingate has 6. Walker has 7. Crowder fouled out with 5. Weaver leading Miller Grove with 14. Tashi Thompson with 12. And Hunt has 10. Deja Clay at the line. Free throw. Short.
7-point game. She's got to at least make one of these to get it up to 8. But right now, if I'm Miller Grove, you have to secure the rebound, John. You don't need a 3. You just need a basket to cut into the lead.
34% free throw shooter coming into the game. Makes the second. Puts it to an 8-point advantage with 86 seconds. Tough man pressure. Durden coming up the floor, bumped by Wingate, and they're going to call the foul.
So now the youth and inexperiences come in and play with Southwest DeKalb. You didn't need to foul Durden there in the full court because she's a little bit out of control. You stay in front of her, and then she'll throw up a shot that you actually want Southwest DeKalb, and now you have a chance to secure the rebound. Now you put it on the free throw line, and now she can score with the clock being stopped.
But she's got to make the free throw. First one, no good. Second free throw. Durden 0-for-6 from the line. Gets her own rebound and another whistle. Looks like another foul on Southwest DeKalb.
Yeah, Southwest DeKalb has to secure those rebounds, especially off the free throw line. Durden has a chance to come up and hit two more free throws, and we'll see what happens.
That's the fifth foul on Dysa Alexander. So she will foul out with 1:20 to go. Finishing the day with 4 points.
Yeah, she's been a great asset to that team today, coming in off the bench. Alexander just been a solid freshman guard and handling the basketball.
Free throw, up and in. Free throw good by Tashi Thompson, makes it 51-44. Each team with one timeout remaining. Both teams now double bonus. Second free throw up, nothing but net. 6-point game in 80 seconds.
Run the baseline, run the baseline, run the baseline. She has it. There's a foul. Oh, that's a steal.
Turnover, Durden knocked out of bounds, and it's going to go which way?
It's going to go towards Miller Grove. Miller Grove with a spot throw in underneath, John.
Durden with the throw in. Going high over the top, cutter. Pass, head fake, looking inside. Ball knocked out of bounds. And Clarissa Weaver was looking for a foul, didn't get it. We're down to 71 seconds. Southwest DeKalb holding on to a 6-point lead. Loop pass inside, Weaver blocked, shot off the hook. And on the floor, looks like another foul. We're going down to the other end to shoot two.
And we talked about Martin in the beginning, John, how athletic this young girl is. That was a great block there off the inbounds to not allow Miller Grove's easy basket. Great block, fantastic block. Not allowing Weaves to get the easy 2 points underneath out of bounds.
Foul on Imani Richardson, her first, as they were diving for the ball on the floor. And there's your double-double from Tiny Smart.
Yeah, 14, that's what she
14 and 15.
And, John, just a sophomore, she's got a bright future. She's going to continue to keep working hard and look like she may have a chance to lead her team to a state championship.
First free throw up and in by Wingate. So, Weaver.
Make these 2 points. We talked about Martin so much. She comes from a background with her father playing at Auburn University with old Charles Barkley. So we got a lot of former basketball players, kids here on the court.
Wingate misses the second, saved in the corner. Huge for Southwest DeKalb. Another foul by Miller Grove. Back to the line to try to build on the lead. With 61 seconds to go, something Miller Grove could not afford.
Well, John, you're exactly right, but this is what I don't like here in the end, John. With a minute and one to go, there's fouls and then there are frustration fouls. And the frustration fouls are the one you have to be aware of, and the officials have to get control of the game here in the late minutes.
Here's the book on DeShazer. Junior guard. First free throw up and misses. Shazer averaging a little over 5 points a game, 62% from the line so far coming into this game. Looking for her ninth point of the day and gets it.
8 point game.
Coming up on 60 seconds to go, regulation, 8 points. Miller Grove's got to do something quick. Durden in the corner.
So let Durden play. Let Durden play.
Missed the runner. Inside, Weaver looking for the putback. Deja Clay defending, no good.
There's a rebounder. Great out.
Wide open all the way down. Ariel Walker, easy two.
Yeah, it started with Martin with the rebound. Deep outlet there. And Walker able to finish there with an easy 2 points.
And they're going to call Wingate for defending. Let's take a look at that last two.
If we had a player of the game, it would definitely have been Martin. But great outlet deeply to Walker. Nice left-hand finish.
That's the fifth foul on Wingate, so she's going to go. She'll finish up with 7 points. Kaylin Kelly will check in, replacing Wingate. Wingate only a 10th grader, so she'll be back for 2 more years under Kathy Walton. First free throw up and in. Now it's back to a 9-point game at 34.6. Katie Hunt's second free throw up and in. 55-47, and here comes that pressure again. Intercepted off the glass, count and the foul.
Hey, it's not over to the fat lady sing, John. And that was a great steal off the inbounds. But again, Martin understands at the made basket, she's not running the baseline. She gets in one spot, and that's where she's passing from, John. And that's actually a crutch, and a disadvantage there, not needed for Southwest DeKalb.
Deja Clay, her third foul. Almost here, like Reggie Miller scoring 5 points.
Watch the spot. Watch the spot.
Now,
does she move, John? She doesn't move. She has a chance to run the baseline.
And they almost got it again.
Exactly. That's what you got to watch. It's a 5-point game with 30.1 seconds to go, John. Miller Grove has a chance to cut into this lead.
And they're giving Miller Grove the ball. Southwest DeKalb touched it last, 32.2. Miller Grove pinned in the corner. Durden trying to figure something out. Launches a three, way short. Ball knocked out of bounds, going to Southwest DeKalb.
Coach Breelove needs to coach that right there. Durden, that's not the one you want to handle the ball. Get it to one of your better players. And that's exactly the young person you don't want to have it. Get it to Weaver, let Weaver make a play. Now, this is a spot throw, and she cannot run the baseline right now. And there's a foul there on the inbounds.
Foul looks like maybe Katie Hunt. And that's Katie Hunt's fifth foul. Katie Hunt will foul out with 15. 23 seconds to go, regulation.
5-point game, John, with 23 seconds to go. We have Martin hit front at the free throw line. Two shots.
Miller Grove has had their chances in the last minute.
Yes, they have, John. And Martin just not making that first one. It's still a two-possession game.
And there's the reaction right there, realizing that it's right there for you. You got to take it. She won't be able to stay in the ball game to do it. 20 seconds. Durden all alone. We'll see if she gets the two this time. Off the glass, up and in, 16.4.
Okay, it's a one-possession game. What can happen? What can happen? There's no five-second count going. There's no five-second count going.
Inbounds, 8.4, down to 7. They didn't call a foul. Southwest DeKalb, finally a foul call with 2.2.
And see, John, what happens is there's some frustration there from Breedlove, and I can understand that. The ball just bounced there for about 3 or 4 seconds. It should have been a five-second count going on the official. That didn't happen. The ball comes in, John, and here we go on the replay. 1, 2. That's not what I'm talking about again, but there was a trap right there and a possible foul. The official didn't call it.
Escape the trap. But before the inbounds was made, the ball was just bouncing
was
by
bounce
itself
at
on the baseline.
Exactly right. And you can't give credit there to the offense. The clock should have stopped, or it should be some reset seconds on the clock.
First free throw, no good for Tynese Martin. Kathy Walton up 3 with 2.2, each team with a timeout to go. This second free throw is huge. Let's see if Coach Breedlove burns her last timeout. Made it. That's a 4-point game. That's it. They're going to call the timeout and use their last.
I see, John, there's a two-possession game, and Miller Grove just scored. That was a great time once she made the basket, call the timeout, and set the defense. Even though it was your last one, that's the one you needed to control the game clock.
Southwest DeKalb up 56-52. Okay, now let's take a look after the last basket.
Now watch the basket.
There's Durden.
You got one timeout left, timeout right now. Now you've got maybe 12 seconds on the clock.
Here's what you're talking about.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 seconds off the clock, and that's game management. Coach Breedlove has to see that. She should have called a timeout when she saw the clock running down. Then the official should have controlled the game of Ashley calling a dead ball and forcing them to pick up the ball.
4-point lead, Southwest DeKalb, 2.2 to go, regulation.
And see, in high school, John, here's the thing, the clock does not stop, but as a head coach, you got to understand, don't get caught in emotion for the game, coach the game. You got one timeout to go, stop the clock then, John, with a timeout.
If you're Kathy Walton, do you just tell your players to get as far away from the ball as humanly possible?
Yes, you do.
Because it doesn't matter.
Yes, you do. You kind of step back, play air back
on your defense,
and let it happen. Exactly. Do not foul.
Do not foul.
Stand still, actually.
Don't touch him. And that'll do it. Shot doesn't count. Miller Grove's comeback comes back just a little short. Southwest DeKalb once again champs girls class 5A. Kathy Walton, champions 2008, 2009, 2010. In the rematch of the 2012 championship game, Southwest DeKalb comes out on top, and they had to survive to do it.
Yeah, John, one word that describes what Southwest DeKalb did tonight was gaining respect. They've got the respect now for Miller Grove, and these young girls are now champions.
Raven Toronto with Kathy Walton.
Coach, are you ready to have a heart attack yet?
Oh, man, I tell you, they've been playing like that all year. One minute they look like they know how to play, next minute they look like they never picked up a ball before.
Well, Coach, let's take it back a year. How much things can change in 1 year? You're walking away the runner-up. Now you came back. You're the winner. Was this the motivation to get here today?
It definitely was. They called it unfinished business, but we were so close last year. And, you know, and credit to them. They're a great team. We felt really horrible after that game. They didn't want that feeling again.
You faced Miller Grove, obviously. This is the fifth time. How much did that prepare you for tonight?
Oh, definitely. I think it was to our advantage because we were so young. And every time we played them, they got a little bit more confident. So it's definitely to our advantage to play them that many times.
If you could have scripted in your mind, would you imagine this opponent and this outcome?
Yes, because our region is really tough. You know, Stevenson, Tucker, they were all ranked top three in the state all year long. We're the ones that creeped up. So it's a tough region. Anybody who comes out of that region is going to be ready for states.
Out of all the state titles, where does this one rank?
Oh, this is amazing because the kids were so young and they're so hungry and they had to learn so much. So it's right up there among the top.
Well, Coach, you're a class act. Congratulations.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much. Okay.
Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Raven Torado, with the victorious Kathy Walton survives the
fourth quarter run by Miller Grove. And Southwest DeKalb gets it one more time. 2008, 2009, 2010. Southwest DeKalb, the champs of Region 6, the champs of 5A. More from Macon when we come back.
It is time now to present the girls' 5A state championship trophy. For that, we go to Ernie Yarbrough of the GHSA.
Coach Walton, on behalf of Dr. Ralph Swearingen and the Georgia High School Association, I want to congratulate you and your team on a great season and a great championship game. Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you so much.
Coach Kathy Walton, you're holding the hardware there. You've held it three times before. Talk about winning number four.
This is very special because we had such a young team. They had to learn how to be team players, to be teammates, and they did it. This is one of the best group of young ladies you ever want to be associated with.
It's a young team, but I know I got a senior right here, Deja Clark. Talk a little bit about what it means to you as a senior to go out with the championship.
It's a blessing. It's really a blessing. If it wasn't for Southwest DeKalb, our fans and everybody, we love y'all so much. Everybody supported us. Everybody supported us. This team. It's a blessing to lead with a ring. It's a blessing.
All right, let's talk to Maya right here. Maya, you had a great game. You're a senior. Talk a little bit about winning this championship trophy. You look at it right there.
I don't know what to say. This is my first one ever, so I'm so happy. And I'm proud of my teammates and my fans and our parents and Coach Watson and the coaches that helped us get where we needed to be.
All right, well, Coach, one more time, congratulations very much. The 5A girls state champions. Congratulations, Southwest DeKalb.
I appreciate it. This is all the Southwest, and this is especially the Pops, because I know Pops helps get through. Thank you, everybody, all the administrators. Thank you very much, GHSA.
All right, the Southwest DeKalb Lady Panthers 5A state champions once again. Now, it's time over to Kat Carney with our tailgate party. Take it away.
Congratulations to the girls 5A champions, and we now get ready for the boys 5A title game. And you know what? The excitement isn't just here in the Coliseum. There's a lot that's going on at gpb.org/sports. While you're there, you can log into the chat room and chat with some of the fans, talk about some of the great plays that are going on. You can also follow us on Twitter and tweet about what you're seeing. But you know what? The real story is on Facebook. We're encouraging everyone to like us. Let us know where you're watching from. And you know what? Social media correspondent Grace Olson is standing here. And you know what? You're uploading a really great video, aren't you?
I am. Our games are live online and on TV. But when they're online, you never know who's watching. We have an exclusive video on Facebook, exactly what Kat's talking about. You can only find it if you like us on Facebook. We're at nearly 3,400 likes. We've been telling you the past 2 days we want to get that number to 5,000, so help us out. Go like us on Facebook. Also, I've been conversing with our fans all night long. On Twitter, I'm asking you to tweet with the hashtag GPBBall during the championships. We have one more game coming up tonight. And I know you'll be watching, I'll be watching. So let's talk about it on Twitter, on Facebook, and on the web on our online chat at gpb.org/sports. Join me online.
And you know what? We ran into some great fans who are from Iowa, Dan and Pernell, who were watching in the restaurant. They're from Iowa, and they're actually going to join us tomorrow.
They are going to join us. It was pretty exciting. You know, they were watching our game. They are not even from the state of Georgia.
I know. So that's, you know what? The excitement extends beyond Georgia. And I'm going to be talking to you a little bit later on, but I'm going to see what Mark is up to. Hey, Mark.
Hey, it's good to see you guys. We're getting ready for basketball this weekend. Yesterday, today, today and tomorrow, but we're also already preparing at GPB for this upcoming Falls Football Fridays in Georgia. Here's John Nelson with a look at what we can look forward to seeing come fall.
This fall, it's Season 3 of Football Fridays in Georgia. Join us each Friday evening starting August 30th with the All Access Pass pregame show as we kick the season off at North Gwinnett High School for a doubleheader with the National High School Gridiron Challenge. Then we continue every Friday all the way on the road to the Dome and finally the 2013 GHSA Championships from the Georgia Dome. On and off the field, GPB Sports showcases the best of high school football, starting with the All Access Pass pregame show. A live full half hour that takes you behind the scenes of the towns and high schools we feature each week.
They are all catching the spirit.
We'll show you how they made it to the semifinals last week at Phil Reese Stadium.
It is winning time live on GPB.
And that's followed by the kickoff of one of the best high school matchups in the state.
Shovel pass, it's picked off. And they're going to take it in for a touchdown.
We bring you Rent Check.
Checking in with the parents.
We're here for a segment we like to call Rent Check. Let's play some Rent Check and see how well you know Trey.
As well as Are You Smarter? As we celebrate the school and community all night
ringing
long.
Ringing the bell, you are right. You are smarter than your students.
Say Football Fridays in Georgia.
From Ringgold to Valdosta and Savannah to LaGrange, it's year three of Football Fridays in Georgia, along with the All Access Pass, all season long on the great GPB.
All right, now back to basketball. We want to welcome in Deja Clay, a senior for Southwest DeKalb. Deja, congratulations. Look at that hat. How's that feel to have that one on there?
It feels wonderful. It feels wonderful. It's a blessing. It's a blessing to play for Coach Kathy Watson. It's a blessing to play with my teammates. We had our ups and downs and everything, but we came out with the win, and I'm so proud of us.
Talk about this game a little bit, because it was a game of runs. You guys had a small lead at the half. You took a big lead in the third quarter. You almost lost that lead. It was back and forth in the fourth quarter.
I mean, it was hard because Middle Grove is a good team, and we played them back and forth during the regular season. So we really just had to come out and just believe in ourselves and believe in our coaches and just have confidence in ourselves, and that's what won us the game.
Well, you know what? The fans believe in you, too. How important are your fans?
They are very important. They support us at school. They support us in every sport we have at Southwest DeKalb. So they're really great.
Deja, talk a little about the program, because you won three Southwest DeKalb, I think, in 2008, 2009, 2010, and now in 2013, you get the fourth one.
I was in ninth grade when we won our last one. So me being in 10th grade, I really want a hat. I really want a ring. I really want to give my coach something that'll mean something. It'll mean something to me and mean something to my team. So our organization is great. I mean, we work hard in practice. We work hard in practice. After practice, we have a bond. So the organization is great.
Talk a little bit about this year's team, because it was a mix. There were some seniors like yourself. There were a lot of young players, freshmen and sophomores as well.
We had to work it in because a lot of our younger players are very good. And we had to believe in our team. We had to believe in each other. So being that we had younger players, it was just we had to believe in them, and we had to make them believe in themselves as well. And being that I'm not a starter, it was great, because just to look at them and to see them get it so young, it was great.
How about that picture right there?
That looks great.
That is wonderful.
That's happiness right there.
It's beyond happiness. It's great.
That is what it's all about, holding up that ring. Give us a one. We're number one.
Number one, baby. Number one. Southwest DeKalb is number one.
All right, Deja Clay, thanks very much. The senior at Southwest DeKalb.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Congratulations. And the boys 5A game is the primetime game tonight. So for what to expect, the region's game preview, let's check in with Gil Tyree and Herb White.
All right, we say good evening, Kat Carney, and we welcome you and yours to our primetime exclusive coverage of the basketball championship. Standing by and getting ready for the 5A battle. It'll be the Red Elephants of Gainesville versus the Miller Grove Wolverines. Gil Tyree along with Herb White. Herb, I want to talk a little bit about the storylines for Gainesville, an opportunity to hit that daily double. They had a football championship, had a chance to add a basketball championship with a win tonight.
Yeah, they kind of remind me of the small schools from the old days where kids had to play football and basketball and every sport in their school. And these guys got kind of a late start getting their groove because they won the football championship mid-December. And as I was talking to DJ Shockley, he played basketball in high school and football. He said it always takes you a few weeks, really, to convert over from playing football to basketball. The conditioning is different. Hand-eye thing is different. So it took a while. But once they hit their stride, man, they hadn't looked back.
And on the other side, Miller Grove, an opportunity to make it five straight championships for Shar White and company.
I tell you what, there's an old expression, they look good getting off the bus. This is an impressive-looking crew of athletes here. They all look like they're 6'5", 6'6", 6'7", and well-built. And I don't know where they keep coming from. They